Sports Radio, AM 1240, KRDO, Colorado Springs. This is Colorado College Hockey on Sports Radio, AM 1240, KRDO. Tiger Hockey is brought to you by Whitney Electric, Home Lighting, Rampart Supply, Cub Foods, Shoemakers, Academy Fence, and Sports Fan. Now, the voice of Tiger Hockey, Jeff Thomas.
Y'all ready for this?
Live from the Cadet Ice Arena on the campus of the United States Air Force Academy, Colorado College Tiger Hockey is on the air. Hello again, everybody, and welcome to one of the greatest rivalries in all of intercollegiate sport, and especially west of the Mississippi, Colorado College and Denver. They've met numerous times. Every show has been eventful. Every play has been exciting. And this year, the gold pan again is at stake, and the Tigers, with a win today or a tie, could clinch the gold pan. But the Tigers, as we use the play on the word pan, have bigger fish to fry. They need a sweep, either this week against the Pioneers, next week against Minnesota, or the following week against Alaska Anchorage.
Obviously, against North Dakota the second night, and last weekend against Wisconsin the second night, we just come out flying. We just have to get consistent because we can play. When we play, I think we're a pretty amazing team to watch.
That's Jason Cudlett, the man who will be in goal tonight for the Colorado College Tigers. Judd Lambert will go tomorrow night. And there's some speculation that Don Lucia may be starting to soft-pedal his claim last week that Jason Cudlett has the job until he loses it. The one thing Don Lucia doesn't want right now with his young team playing in the most important time of the year, the stretch run, is to create a goalie controversy.
Well, the plan going into this weekend is to play Cuggy on Friday night and Judd on Saturday. I think that Judd is 2-0 in his last two starts at DU Arena. Cuggy won the game at home against DU earlier in the season. So, I mean, no, it's not a situation where we're going to play Jason Cugnet the rest of the year. Judd Lambert's an awful good goaltender, and looks like we're going to split him this weekend.
So with the goaltending question out of the way, we can launch into the Coach's Corner, a conversation with the head coaches of both the Colorado College Tigers and the DU Pioneers. We begin with Don Lucia, and we begin where we began last week, and that's with that multiple-choice question, the $64,000 question. Does the A team show up tonight, the B team show up, or honestly, Jeff, I don't know.
I don't know. I think we'll play a good game today, Jeff, and who knows if that'll be enough, but I think that we will get a good game out of our kids, and I think they're going to be excited to play tonight, and we have to be because we're seeing an awful good Denver team.
You might also see a real good crowd tonight, too, because they know that this is an important series, and they have to be with you and get you ignited.
Well, we need to hold serve at home. I think that's a big thing. We've got the first game at home this time. Last time we opened up at Denver. So we need the crowd. I think they're going to be jam-packed in here tonight, and I think they'll be loud and vocal, as usually the CCDU crowds are.
Other than Brian Waldo and Jason Goodmanson, the flu bug or anything in practice change your lineup up from where you finished at Wisconsin?
No, nothing. The only thing that's been a little difficult this year is the difficult practice week because of the block ending on Wednesday, and we took Monday off, and a lot of guys were pretty stressed out on Tuesday just because the classes were ending. So, but we had, I thought, a good, pretty good practice Wednesday and Thursday, and hopefully we'll be ready tonight.
We've talked before about young players understanding this time of the year, and I think you've said that they do, and that your upperclassmen as leaders have tried to convey that. Is it time for all of that talk and even leading by example over with now, and it's time just to each player focus on the ice and play?
Well, I think so, Jeff. This is the time of the year where the players have to play. I always say the horse has got to run this time of the year, and goaltending becomes huge, and your star players have to play like stars. And I think whichever team, not only this weekend but from here on out, does that will determine ultimately who has a good playoff run, who ends up in the NCAA tournament from the WCHA.
Jason Cugnet goes in the nets tonight and Judd Lambert tomorrow night.
Well, Cuggy, I think, has earned the right to play. He beat Denver here. Judd has won his last two starts at DU Arena. So hopefully that'll work again as it did earlier in the season. But Cuggy's our future, and we need to get him game time for next year.
And when you say game time, meaningful game time, games that really count.
Yeah, and I think that he has played the last two starts have been very meaningful games. We lost first night against North Dakota. He won the game the second night. We lost the first night against Wisconsin. He came back to win the second night as well. So I think those are two pressure-packed games, as is tonight.
Let's talk positioning for a moment. You spent 2 weeks on the road. Now the next four, you have more home games than the people above you, and you're playing some of the people above you. You're still in pretty good shape if the kids will take care of their own business.
Well, I feel like if we really want to solidify ourselves maybe in the top three, that we have to go 4-2. I think if we go 4-2, that would give us 40 points in the season, and that would give us top three. But I mean, look at right now, Jeff, we can finish anywhere from second to seventh. It's just that close at this late date.
Well, that means a sweep somewhere. Where do you have that penciled in as where you would like to see it?
Well, it's hard to say, but, you know, probably the one that would be the most important is if we could get two from Minnesota here next weekend, just because they're the team that's a few points ahead of us, and that would give us the tiebreaker. If we even split with Denver this weekend, we've got them 3-1. We've got the tiebreaker. If we were to sweep Minnesota, that would put us at 3-1 with Minnesota as well. But, you know, right over our shoulders, Duluth. Duluth's only 4 points back, and they don't have that difficult of a schedule after this weekend from here on out, and they have the tiebreaker against us. So it's going to be a very interesting final 3 weeks.
And it's going to keep everybody on their toes. That's the head coach of the Tigers, Don Lucia. When we take a timeout and come back, we'll hear from George Gwozdecki, the head coach of the DU Pioneers. That and more to come. Stay with us. You're listening to Tiger Hockey on Sports Radio.
It's like the saying goes, there's always free cheese in a mousetrap. Hi, Dave Workman, president of Soundtrack. You'll hear a lot of stores boast, we have the lowest prices around. It's almost like cheese in a mousetrap. In reality, all consumer electronics dealers price shop each other's stores to stay competitive. And that's why the same product will be about the same price no matter where you go. At Soundtrack, price is only the beginning, not the end. We still believe in this thing called value. In fact, we built a 28-year reputation around it. It's things like an uncompromising attitude towards customer service, offering more choices in every category we sell, extensively training our sales specialists, or backing your purchase with an ultimate 60-day price guarantee. Now that's value. So if it's a complete electronics experience you want and a low price, then come to the electronics specialist. Come to Soundtrack.
And look for our big 8-page insert in Saturday's Rocky Mountain News, Denver Post, and other Front Range newspapers. Soundtrack. Big names, little prices, guaranteed.
Honey, I'm sorry.
You can fix it. Over a candlelight dinner at the Briarhurst. Entrees start at $10.50. The food's delicious. Service is great. The atmosphere is comfortable and quiet, so you can talk over a great meal. The Briarhurst, the perfect place to get away for a couple of hours of quality time. Enjoy each other's company. It's an investment in your relationship.
The CC Tigers have proven to be leaders on the ice, and the Overhead Door Company continues to be the leaders in residential and commercial garage doors and openers.
Look out to the leader, Overhead Doors.
Since 1940, the Colorado College Bookstore has offered an impressive selection of books for studies, reference, as well as leisure. You'll also find CC clothing, greeting cards, and office supplies. The Colorado College Bookstore at 902 North Cascade in the lower level of the Warner Center.
Welcome back to the Cadet Ice Arena, site of tonight's all-important WCHA showdown between the Colorado College Tigers and the DU Pioneers. Earlier, you heard Don Lucia say that maybe a sweep against Minnesota might be the most important one to register if his team has to go 4-2 down the stretch. And it's a good thing he has targeted the Gophers. They're on top of Duluth right now, 3-1 in the first period of play, and we'll be updating those scores, the key ones, Duluth and Minnesota, North Dakota, on the road at Northern Michigan, and St. Cloud facing Wisconsin. Those all have a significant impact on the game that's about to be played here tonight. But now over to the University of Denver Pioneer dressing room, and George Gwozdecki, a man that Don Lucia has defeated five consecutive games dating to the first game of the regular season last year, and that disappointing loss in the Denver Cup. His team had the best record over the last 20 games in the WCHA and until it took a tumble in Duluth last weekend, where they dropped two to Mike Sertich's Bulldogs. But there are six games to play, and the Pioneers are still in control of their own destiny in terms of getting to that last spot, but they've got 3 points to make up, and the team needs to be eager for the challenge.
Well, there's no question that we put ourselves in a little bit of a bind here. We didn't expect to go up there and not get anything, but Duluth played extremely well against us. You got to give them full credit for that. But now we put ourselves in a situation where we've got to go, I think, at least 5-1 to at least get a home ice advantage in the first round of the playoffs. And with six games to go, that's a pretty difficult chore for us. I mean, but you know, the good thing is we play the three teams who are ahead of us. You know, we play these next three weekends, and that's good. Or three of the teams that we play. So we definitely are planning on it. We're looking on that. Obviously, this weekend's a big weekend for us in many ways because of the great rivalry we have with CC and the fact that we haven't done real well against them. In fact, we were talking the other day, not one of our players on our team has ever won down here. And this is the last opportunity of a regular season game that our seniors will have a chance of winning in this building. I think that's a little bit of a motivational factor for our kids. Now you heard me say regular season. I've looked at different pairings of what might happen, but you know, the strange things could happen. I mean, you know, these two teams could be playing together again in 4 weeks from now, either here or up in Denver, depending on how the standings shape up. So stranger things could happen. But, boy, I'd say that would be real interesting if that ever happened.
What has your kids been like in practice this week? Did the last weekend set them back emotionally, George, or were they eager to come to practice and get after it again this week?
Well, you know, I think if we weren't playing Colorado College this weekend, perhaps it might have taken us a little longer to get back to an emotional readiness. But by Tuesday, the kids were ready to go. I mean, it was, no question, it was disappointing. But we had a pretty good meeting on Tuesday and Wednesday and really discussed some things about what we wanted to accomplish, not only this weekend, but down the road, and examined what we needed to do better. I think the enthusiasm was quickly back in practice, and I thought we had real good practices Wednesday and yesterday, and I think we're ready to play this weekend. There's no question in my mind.
When you come together against Colorado College, have you set your plans for the weekend as far as goaltending, or are you going to take that night tonight?
Well, right now my plan is that Jim Mullen will get the start tonight and that Steve Wagner will get the start tomorrow night. And I don't see, unless something earth-shattering happens, Jim Mullen lights it on fire tonight, then maybe, you know, he might persuade me that he might get the start tomorrow night. But right now I'm planning that Steve will come back tomorrow night for us.
Well, Jim has sort of been a bright spot, noticing the numbers. I think he finished with CC in the fall with a .845, and now his saves percentage is .90-something. So he's really stepped his game up since you've seen CC.
Yeah, he's played he's played real well since early December. And really, I think the only average game that he has had was last Friday in Duluth. I thought he really was not real sharp and struggled at times, and as our whole team did, but he's been so strong since December and really keeping us in games and giving us a chance to win games.
Yes, it is Jim Mullen who will be in goal tonight, and that's our Coach's Corner with head coach George Gwozdecki. We'll be joining television in just a moment. Stay with us. You're listening to Tiger Hockey on Sports Radio.
You finally made the decision you're going to buy it. Yet as you look, the frustration grows and grows. You visit stores that have the product you want, but there's no one to talk to. And when you finally find a clerk, it's not their department, and they haven't got a clue. When was the last time you shopped in a store that specialized in what you were looking for? Here's Alicia from Shoemakers.
Helping you is what we specialize in. For over 65 years, Shoemakers Camera Shops has been helping, yes, helping people like you make good decisions about the photographic equipment that's right for you. When you shop Shoemakers, you'll find that everyone on our staff is passionate about photography. The value of quality service is immediately apparent. We take the time to find out what your needs are, then match you with the equipment that will deliver the best pictures you've ever taken. I'd like to personally invite you to our stores to experience the true value of real customer service.
Shoemakers Camera Shops, downtown at Kiowa and Tejon, and on the west side at 19th and Uinta next to the 7-Eleven.
It's the number one cause of household electrical fires: improperly used extension cords. Don't gamble with your family's safety. Instead, consider these electrical safety tips from Whitney Electric. Check extension cords often for worn and frayed areas. If cords are worn to the touch, discontinue their use immediately. But the best electrical safety precaution is to add another receptacle in the area where the extension cord is being used. For a safe bet, call 473-4212 and connect with the winning team at Whitney Electric.
I'm Bob Harris with SmartBeat. to tell you that SmartBeat fat-free cheese slices are now certified by the American Heart Association. SmartBeat, the only cheese slices with no fat, no cholesterol, and no lactose. For a great cheddar taste and a good source of protein and calcium, with absolutely no fat, cholesterol, or lactose, low in calories and sodium, look for SmartBeat, displaying the American Heart Association heart check mark on the package. Don't just say cheese, say SmartBeat.
It's a rivalry of the first magnitude in yet another pressure-packed weekend in the WCHA. And the gold pan is at stake when Colorado College meets Denver. Welcome to another in the interesting rivalry between the Tigers and the Pioneers. CC begins the weekend in third place, the Pioneers in sixth. And you'll see it all unfold here on Cable Channel 70 from KRDO TV 13, and you'll hear it on Sports Radio AM 1240 KRDO. The Tigers, as we mentioned, trying to get the first goal of each game. And as you see at Wisconsin last week, it didn't happen on opening night. The Badgers went on to post a victory. But on Saturday, Don Lucia stressed defense to key the offense. Look at how many Tigers are in front of the Badger net, and this goal by Darren Clark broke the game wide open. And the rest of CC's game, as a result, fell into place. The Tigers did everything well, including springing Brian Swanson out of the penalty box, and then he went in on Dobbin Speck and helped put the game away. Can the Tigers put two games together? And what will be the key to that happening this evening?
Five and six goals in our losses and stuff, and we can't do that if we want to get these sweeps.
Last weekend against Wisconsin, the second night, we just come out flying. We just have to get consistent because we can play. When we play, I think we're a pretty amazing team to watch.
The Tigers are a team to watch, and now they're tied for third with North Dakota in command of the race for now, except we have just heard that North Dakota fell to Northern Michigan tonight, 2-1. In Marquette, the Sioux are at Northern tonight where they lost 2-1. Wisconsin has a big series at St. Cloud. Now Denver, as we look at the next half of the standings, is in a tie and in a more desperate situation tonight with Duluth, while Anchorage, Northern, and Tech hope to make a mess of things, as Northern did tonight for North Dakota, for the rest of the contenders. This game is big tonight because in the next four, CC has the most home games, and they face second-place Minnesota here next week. Now, CC has a rougher go when you look at the final six games. When it comes down to those games against the everybody else has four games against those bottom teams. And for the most part, they are at home while the Tigers will be on the road. One other key is goaltending. Denver's Jim Mullen has lost only once to a WCHA team since Colorado College played the Pioneers back in the fall. He's raised his saves percentage from 84 to 90. He's playing significantly better now than he did earlier in the year. If the Tigers are to finish in the top two in the standings, that means they're going to have to get by Denver, Minnesota, and Anchorage in serious fashion. And of course, that last series with Anchorage is on the road. All one player, but just a few moments. Stay with us. Tiger Hockey is next.
You live for sports. 24 hours a day, you eat, drink, and sleep sports. But you can't follow every game all the time. Until now. ESPN and the area's leading pager provider, AirTouch Paging, have teamed up to provide a service made for sports hounds like you. ESPN Net to Go. With your alphanumeric pager from AirTouch Paging, you'll now be able to get the latest scores for all major pro and collegiate team sports. Along with score updates, ESPN Net to Go brings you game information and details, plus exclusive ESPN features like sports headline news. With AirTouch Paging and ESPN Net to Go, you'll be the first to know what's happening in the world of sports, no matter where you are or what you're doing. Score updates every 5 minutes, top 25 college rankings, game schedules with point spread, and much, much more. It's as close as your alphanumeric pager from AirTouch Paging and ESPN Net to Go. Visit AirTouch Paging at Carefree and Academy behind Bennigan's and check out the latest way to use your pager with ESPN Net to Go. Call 573-6500.
Phil Longford is seriously overstocked with used cars.
The answer.
The most extraordinary values ever.
For a limited time.
300 quality used cars and trucks, all from at least $500 and up to $2,500 below current NADA book.
That's right.
300 used vehicles priced a minimum of $5 and up to $2,500 below NADA.
Even Phil Longford's outlet center is overstocked with 100 used cars and trucks.
All $49.95 and under.
A special group of 30 used cars under $19.95.
Even 20 used cars under $1,000.
And listen to this. Phil Longford's Outlet Center is offering $10 cars.
That's right, $10 for a used car.
Phil Longford Used and Outlet Center are giving you the most extraordinary values ever.
300 quality used cars and trucks.
From $500 and up to $2,500 below NADA book.
If you want to save big money,
visit Phil Longford Used and Outlet Center in Motor City.
Today.
Plus, check us out on the web at www.philong.com.
Plus tax based on current NADA Retail Consumer Edition 53B.
In here tonight. The crowd is definitely ready for tonight's contest between the Tigers and the Pioneers. And before we get underway, there was some news announced in the Springs today from Athletic Director Marty Scarano about the Tigers of Colorado College and the Pioneers of Denver getting together on a new agreement for the Denver Cup.
We're all excited to announce that we have a joint venture and signing a six-year contract with University of Denver to be a participant in the Denver Cup starting next year and for the subsequent 5 years following. We look forward to a great affiliation that's real attractive for all of us involved. And we want to bring in the best talent in the United States. Next year it's going to be Miami of Ohio and New Hampshire. And we look hopefully towards bringing the best teams in the East and the CCHA and every year after that.
That's Marty Scarano, the athletic director of Colorado College. You're looking at him. He works the penalty box here. And he also had some interesting notes on what the CC and DU are doing with regards to the possibility of landing the Final Five, the WCHA's postseason tournament in the state of Colorado.
Again, us in Denver are going to partner on a proposal this spring at the WCHA meeting to bring the WCHA Final Five to McNichols Arena in 1999. And we're real happy with that as well, because WCHA Final Five has never left the state of Minnesota or Wisconsin, and we want to show all the people that we have some Western hospitality.
That's Marty Scarano, the athletic director for Colorado College. So some interesting things to look forward to. CC will play in the Denver Cup for the next 6 years. They'll be spending Christmas in Colorado. And then, of course, in 2 years, they hope to have the WCHA's Final Five at McNichols Arena and, of course, eventually at the Pepsi Center as well. You look at Jason Cugnet if you're watching on cable channel 70 from KRDO TV 13 at Century Communications, the man who was charged with getting the Tigers off on the right foot this evening here at the Cadet Ice Arena against the DU Pioneers. And we'll just see how strong he will play tonight. At the other end, Jim Mullen in goal for the DU Pioneers. Tonight's game brought to you in part by Home Lighting, Academy Fence, Rampart Supply, the Sports Fan, Shoemakers, Whitney Electric, Lovin & Associates Realtors, and City Line Mortgage. And now, time for the fastest game in America, the Western Collegiate Hockey Association, underway at the Cadet Ice Arena. Tigers try to shove it in. They got a man open. Brian Swanson launches from the left point, comes to the right point on the rebound. Slapped into the corner by Bob Needham. Tigers on the attack. Pioneers try to clear it up the far side. And a good check by Scott Swanson keeps it in. Then it's kept in by Cam Fryway. And now the Pioneers get on track. Travis Smith rolls it into the far corner of the Tiger zone. Their first penetration of the Tiger end. Behind the net, five players in a scramble for it. It drifts to the far boards, and Sam Fryway backhands it out. Darren Clark racing on net, but coming out ahead of Kerlick is Jim Mullen, and the Tigers, Kobe Peterson picked up the loose puck just as it crossed the blue line, tried to march in, but one of his teammates was in deep.
from the previous rush and an offside call. It's just been announced to the crowd here that Northern Michigan has beaten North Dakota 2-1. We are hearing, and this is somewhat of a surprise, that Northern Michigan scored into an empty net, that in a 1-1 tie, Dean Blaze pulled his goaltender to go for the win, and Northern Michigan hit the open net for the victory. So Northern Michigan helps the Tigers gain a couple of points on North Dakota should CC be successful here tonight. Jason Cugnett clears it up the far side, but it connects with the protective netting and goes out of play. We'll take our first time out of the night. We'll be right back at scoreless here. First minute is over at the Cadet Ice Arena.
We don't think much about heart disease until it touches our lives. But this Valentine's Day, New England Financial Services is asking you not only to think about heart disease, but also to give from the heart. On February 14th, representatives from the New England will be visiting local businesses selling Valentine's Day hearts. Your donation will benefit the American Heart Association and could also win you round-trip airfare on United Airlines to anywhere in the continental U.S. If your business would like to participate, call New England Financial Services at 632-8864. Your Southern Colorado representative of the New England.
Puck at neutral ice as we come back, drifting towards the Tiger end. Stu Bodker picks it up in front of the Tiger bench, sends it the DU Pioneers way. Highs field it, send it to neutral ice, gathered in by CC, backhanded by Ian Peterson. This one catches. And they'll be a face-off. Caught from the Tiger, the Denver blue line. The Tigers will face off just to the near side, above the Tiger, DU blue line. It's won by John Austin to Bob Needham. Touch pass to Chad Hartnell. Hartnell races into the near corner, sends it behind the net. Off the skate of John Austin, back to Hartnell. Hartnell tries to center, it comes off the back iron. Pioneers swipe at it, don't get it out. Needham takes a drive. Oh, and Mullen, a glove save with Chad Hartnell looking to deflect it right in his face. And Mullen reached over the stick of Hartnell and made the stop. Mullen with a 90% saves percentage with the Pioneers after starting out with a very difficult 6-8 games. John Austin wins the draw. Puck goes far corner. Denver zone. Austin, Hartnell try to free it up. It comes to Travis Shane. Wrist shot. He can't field it. Tanberg fights through it. Voorhees fights through it. Comes up with the puck. Has it poke checked off his stick. Tanberg is knocked down. No call. Puck free. Hitting starts to pick up in the corner. Now it's frozen to the boards and four players wrapped up on the puck. And Mike Schmidt may have to blow the whistle here pretty quickly. 17-14 left in the first period. We're scoreless here at the Cadet Ice Arena. Tanberg still wrestling with Petri Gunther. And now we get a whistle. And the puck is frozen along the board. We'll take another timeout, come back for the faceoff in the DU zone after you hear this.
It's the number one cause of household electrical fires. Improperly used extension cords. Don't gamble with your family's safety. Instead, consider these electrical safety tips from Whitney Electric. Check extension cords often for worn and frayed areas. If cords are worn to the touch, discontinue their use immediately. But the best electrical safety precaution is to add another receptacle in the area where the extension cord is being used. For a safe bet, call 473-4212 and connect with the winning team at Whitney Electric.
Puck near corner, Denver zone. Travis Smith behind the Denver net, being bird dogged by Brian Swanson. It comes to the point. Cal Elfring tries to keep it alive, but Gavin Morgan gets it out. Picked up by Cryway, wants to send it in. He's bottled up. Now he gets some help from Elfring. Touch pass ahead to Darren Clark. Tries to center. Picked up by Elfring. Wrist shot. Mullen the glove save. Sets it on the ground. Now covers up. Brian Hacker wanted to sweep it out of the zone, but the Pioneer goaltender froze it up. Faceoff will come near circle in the Denver zone. Brian Swanson looks to win the draw. Stacked up against Gavin Morgan. Swanson wins. It comes to Clark. Clark ridden off the puck. Pioneers get out. They're back 2-on-2. Lead pass connects, but Kel Elfring and Paul Johnson break it up. Johnson in the corner, sends it through the end zone to Cam Fryway, far side. Up along the far boards, lead pass to Darren Clark, has to reach behind himself to field it, sends it into the Zamboni corner, comes out behind the net. Brian Swanson after, tries to play the body. The Pioneers bring the puck up the near side. And Morgan steps around Clark. Left wing pass for Brouzon, long. Looks like an icing call coming to the Pioneers. They'll go back into their own end. We'll take another timeout and return. You're listening to Tiger Hockey on Sports Radio and watching on Cable Channel 70.
We've been in our house for about 12 years.
Yeah, it was time to change the carpet.
Hi, Bob Vila with another comforting carpet story from Sears.
We didn't want to make any mistakes. Sears did everything possible to make us comfortable.
Tell me about Sears' premier installation package.
Sears moved the furniture, picked up the old carpet, put down the new carpet. What's a new living room?
That's comforting to hear. And so is all carpet on sale at Sears. Every beautiful yard on sale through Saturday. Sale excludes buyer's best buys. Sears, where the experience is as comfortable as the carpet.
Pioneers bring the puck into the Tiger end. It goes behind the net and pops in front of the net. And then Jason Cugnet has to hang on. There'll be a face-off in the Colorado College zone. And the time remaining is 15:52 in the first period. We are still scoreless here at the Cadet Ice Arena. Good crowd on hand, and they start to talk it up a little bit. Been a great week for hockey in the Pikes Peak region. The state semis and finals Monday and Wednesday, Cheyenne Mountain with a second straight state championship. And then, of course, President's Day Youth Hockey Tournament underway. This game here tonight, and then in Denver tomorrow night. So if you're a hockey fan, you're in paradise this week in the Pikes Peak region. Puck through the far corner, Tiger zone. Needham tries to get it out. It comes to the right point. Wrist shot by Ritson is knocked down in traffic. Goes to the far side. Ritson keeps it in at the point. Looks down low, runs it through the corner. Scott Swanson will pick it up. Over on the near side, he's hipped off the puck. Bodker comes in to help out. Antti Laaksonen is there as well. Picked up by Toby Peterson. Flips it high through neutral ice. This is running deep into the Denver zone. Clears the end line. And another icing call, this time on the Tigers. So they'll bring it back into the Colorado College end for a faceoff. And we will keep it right here for the moment. Again, the Northern Michigan Wildcats, who gave Minnesota all they could handle and more last week, both nights at the Mariucci Arena, knocking off North Dakota tonight and scoring into an empty net goal in the dying stages of the game at the Lakeview Ice Arena along the shores of Lake Superior. A shot off the faceoff by Petri Gunther wide. Rebound comes far side. Touch pass Travis Shane to Chad Hartnell. Hartnell wants to run it ahead to John Austin. Has to split the defense with it. It rolls through the end zone. Slowed by Mullen. Pushed up the far side by Gunther. Grabbed by Bjork. Pushed off his stick. Now carried out of the zone by Corbett. Corbett comes in at the right point. Wrist shot. Cugnet gets the stick down. Deflects the puck. Corbett launched in a hurry from just below the Tiger blue line, and it was deflected into the protective netting, and play is stopped. So look at Anders Bjork, one of the Flying Swedes. Erik Andersson, the captain, is 6'3", 216 from Stockholm. Bjork is 6'3", 206 from Stockholm. He comes back. He's a junior. Andersson is a senior, as is the Finn, Antti Laaksonen. Puck goes far side boards. Tigers dig it out. Shane and Austin working on it. Pioneers pick it up center. Broken up by the Tigers. It drips in front of the net. Slapped to the point. Pioneers keep it in. Their first real good buzz of the night. Near side to Petri Gunther, another foreigner from Finland. He can't quite handle it. He's also a senior, but it goes behind the Tiger net. Centering pass misfires. And another shot goes in, but they're going to wave it off. A second shot. There's a holding call coming. A penalty to Denver. And that eradicates the goal. Pushed in from the right point. As a man out front with a holding penalty denies the Pioneers first blood tonight, and the Pioneer bench is not upset about the call. Penalty comes with 14:34 left, and we'll see the wrist shot here. We cannot see the hold out front, but it was there. And the goal is disallowed. So the Pioneers go down a man, lose a goal, and lose a man. Penalty comes with 5:26 expired, and it's Anders Bjork
in the box for holding. Whistle, stoppage of play as the puck comes to neutral ice and will start again. Faceoff will come in the Denver zone, just above the right circle with 14:27 left. And the Tigers on the power play, first time tonight. They broke their power play drought last week at Wisconsin. Tigers also have a pretty good penalty kill string going. They haven't allowed a power play goal in six games. Pioneers sweep it out after the faceoff. Runs deep into the Tiger end, slowed by Cugnet, picked up by Scott Swanson. He's headed back up the ice, dumps it far side, slapped in by Danny Peters. Through the corner it comes. Pioneers pick it up, try to clear it out, and do, as they play it off the near boards and split Peters and Swanson. Peters fields it high on the Tiger end, lead pass off the stick of Cam Cryway. Well, the officials say no, and the Tigers will get hit with an icing call. So on this power play, they will bring it back into the Tiger zone. We are hearing that Minnesota Duluth has gone ahead of Minnesota. We'll have to check on that score. The Gophers were up 3-1. And we understand that Minnesota Duluth has taken a 4-3 lead over the Gophers with three unanswered goals. And we also see Richard Quincy and Bob Needham headed to the dressing room. Needham is walking under his own power, but apparently has been injured. With 14:01 left here in the first period. Scoreless first period. Tigers on the power play for a minute 32. Scott Swanson stick handles through neutral ice. Lead pass to Brian Swanson. He's in. Rashot Mullen takes it in the chest and hangs on. Swanson, Fryway, and Clark waiting for the rebound. And Mullen says there won't be one with 13:49 remaining. And a faceoff will come in the Denver zone. Tiger pride is a good way to get involved with Colorado College Tiger Athletics. Today, a terrific luncheon at Carrabba's on the south end of town. Next week, Tiger Pride is sponsoring another luncheon. Doug Woog and Don Lucia will be the featured speakers, and you'll get a first-hand look at the construction at the Colorado Springs World Arena. There'll be a display on site. You'll see how the seats are starting to go up, or at least the pre-stress for the seat configuration is going up. And if you want to be a part of this luncheon next week and get on site to see the new arena, 389-6336, Tiger Pride. Wrist shot off the faceoff. Mullen the save, rebound. Shot, Toby Peterson, blocker stop, rebound, loose, rebound. Oh, and Mullen gets a cover up on both shots. And we've got illegal use of the stick whistled by assistant referee Tim Swider, as the Tigers apparently got their stick up too high. And that stops play. But Stu Bodker, John Austin, Toby Peterson were all down low on that power play chance and got an opportunity to try to make something happen. Now let's see, Tim Swider and Mike Schmidt are talking over in front of the penalty boxes, and we're getting a high-sticking call, and this one is apparently being made by Tim Swider, and it looks like it's the Pioneers taking the penalty. So the Tigers will get a 5-on-3 advantage, and a unique call by the assistant referee stepping in to advise Mike Schmidt of the call. The Pioneers. Coach George Gwozdecki is asking Tim Swider what this is all about. Now, that's how rare these calls are, that the coaches question them when they come up. And we'll see if there's a stick used up high here somewhere. Not there. Not there. Maybe there. Mike Schmidt seemed to be watching everything. But Warren Smith is in the box for high sticking. Tigers with a 5-on-3 early. Big break for CC. Right side to Root. Root at the point. Now to Elfring. Elfring looks inside. Back to the captain. Looks down low. Slides it near side to Austin. Back to Rude. Rude looking down low. Tigers closing the box. Elfring in front. Save Mullen. Rebound. Ricochets behind the net. Pioneers try to sweep it out. Rude keeps it in. Shovels it across to Elfring. Lines up. Takes the drive. Knocked down in traffic. Elfring retrieves it. Looks inside. In the corner. Up top. Back to Elfring at the point. Also has Peterson up high. Now to Root again. Now Kobe goes down low. Far side to Elfring. Near side to Root. 29 seconds left on the 5-on-3. Root's going to wind up. Slides it to Elfring. Looks down low. to Bodker. Bodker backs off into the corner to Elfring. Wrist shot. Mullen to save. Rebound loose. Tigers retrieve it. Bodker up top to Rude. Steps around one man. Gets down low. 14 seconds left. 5-on-3. Rude brings it along the near boards. Comes up top. Tigers rotate around. Wrist shot. Knocked down. Off the skate of Eric Anderson. It comes back to neutral ice. First penalty is going to expire as Kobe Peterson brings it back in, and he's got to wait for help. The Tigers have changed the power play unit. Rude's going to stay on. Now they have 48 seconds left. 5-on-4. Cam Cryway leaves it in the corner for Clark. Pioneers intercept. Try to clear it out. Kept it by Brian Swanson. Works his way to the near side. Up top to Rude. Now back to Brian. Looks inside. Down low to Darren Clark. Looking for the give and go. It's not there. Deflects off the skate of one of the Pioneers. And Mullen covers up as Cryway takes a whack at it. And the Pioneers are weathering a furious assault on their net by the Tigers. Although they haven't gotten many quality shots, they are attacking the net. And with 12:11 to go, 31 seconds left on the power play, the Tigers will at least win another faceoff in the Denver zone. Brian Swanson will step in against Gavin Morgan. Pioneers took two penalties in less than a minute, giving CC a 5-on-3 and now a 5-on-4 for another 31 seconds. Jim Mullen had a little equipment adjustment to make and is now ready to go again. Faceoff near circle. And Swanson is ready. Wins the draw. Comes to the point to Scott Swanson. Back to Brian. And now down low to Darren along the end line. Center is broken up. It drifts towards the net. Clark picks it up. Tries to center. Pioneers sweep it near side. Look for an avenue to get it out. And they do. It drifts towards the far corner. Jason Cugnet steps in front of it. Tigers have to hurry back to get balanced off for one more attack before the power play comes to an end. Right wing to Brian Swanson. Pioneers field it, try to kick it out. Scott Swanson keeps it in center, down low. Oh, Cryway was fed brilliantly by Brian Swanson, but didn't have his stick down. Pioneers penalty is over. Tigers keep it in. Now near side to Darren Clark, to Brian Swanson behind the net. It drifts past him, picked up by Corbett. Sends it off the far side, kept in by Elfring. Then it gets off his stick to neutral ice. He retrieves it, picks it up to Darren Clark. Clark brings it in. Whistle. Tigers are offside. 11:25 remaining now in period number one. And now George Gwozdecki wants to talk again to one of the officials, trying to get the ear of Mike Schmidt. And Mike comes over to have his ear bent a little bit. And I don't know what George is upset about, unless it was the delay on the call for offside. Faceoff will come above the Denver blue line. George battling the flu and a head cold has really been under the weather this week. Did not come down for the luncheon today. Sent one of his assistants, who did a good job. And everybody seemed to have a good time. And I'll tell you, if George Gwozdecki misses a meal or an attempt to speak, he's got to be sick, because those are two things he loves to do. And I don't mean that in a derogatory fashion. He loves being around people, loves having a chance to sit down and have a meal with fellow hockey fans and to talk about his team. So he had to be really feeling weak not to make the trip down. Eric Rude with the puck off the faceoff. Sends it near side. Pioneers intercept. Rude pokes it back towards the zone. Carried in by Carpen. Working free against Gunther. To KJ4. He centers Tanberg. He didn't have his stick down. Puck drifts far side. Tanberg tries to forecheck to keep the puck alive, and it works. Voorhees takes it away, slides it to the point. Elfring lines up. Wrist shot deflected in traffic. Lift rebound is loose. Tigers get one shot off. Pioneers smother that one, though, and try to get it out. It comes to the near side, picked up by Patterson, clears it out, comes right to Rude. He allows Carpen to try to backhand it in. Carpen gets a kick right in the chin, and no call right in front of the assistant referee Tim Swider. Pioneers have it on the Tiger, and this is Comrie, their leading scorer, goes to the far side. Penalty coming to CC. Pioneers take a drive. Off the ice comes Jim Mullen, and the Tigers will have their first man in the box tonight. And it will come with 10:36 left in the period, and we'll see Denver's power play here in period number one for the first time this evening. Eric Rude is headed to the box. Denver took the first two infractions. This one comes 9 minutes and 24 seconds in. And the captain will sit for 2 minutes for tripping. Denver on the power play, first time tonight, and the Pioneers are seventh in the league. Their overall percentage is 18.2. On the road, they are 14.6. Tigers have done six consecutive games without giving up a power play goal. And the Pioneers cleared out of themselves. And we have just seen a Pioneer hung an effigy here along the near side in the Cadet Ice Arena. Pioneers get it out of the zone, bring it up the right side. Anderson, far side, brings it to the point, winding up, taking the drive is Murphy. It's defeated into the near side. Puck free along the boards. Tigers trying to kick it out. Pioneers pick it up, backhanded into the corner again. Scott Swanson bottles up one man. Toby Peterson gets the puck, sends it ahead to Stu Bodker, and Bodker was trying to wrap it around Petri Gunther and break in shorthanded. He missed on the puck. Gunther fields it in the Zamboni corner, still stick handling, brings it in at the left point, goes all the way along the blue line to the far side. Comrie keeps it in, sends it down low, through the corner it goes, behind the net. Elfring's on it quickly. Elfring tries to clear it out. It's poked off his stick by the Pioneers. It drifts into the corner. After it goes Loxonen. Loxonen brings it near side. Now up top, one-timer, knocked in traffic off the skate of Eric Anderson to the near side, off the stick of John Newman. Grabbed by the Tigers, Hartnell does not get it out, and it squirts along the near board. Scott Swanson picks it up, finds an avenue, and drives it to the length of the ice. Picked up behind the net by Newman, headed back the other way, kicks it up to Warren Smith. He fans on the deflection into the Tiger end. And, oh, they wave off the icing call. Oh, the effigy player that was hung on the far side has fallen apart, and the debris from it has landed on the ice, so play has to be stopped. The Pioneer hung an effigy, and you can see the debris, the bottom half of the Pioneer and the newspaper, being picked up by assistant referee Tim Schweider. Certainly not in his job description, not in his contract. He'll not get overtime for this. But someone will have to go up top now and haul the rest of that turkey in, or the stuffings of the upper half of the body will fall. And they're going to stop play here until that gets done. We'll remind you that you're listening to Tiger Hockey on Sports Radio AM 1240, KRDO Radio, Colorado Springs, Colorado, and you are watching on cable channel 70 from KRDO TV 13 and Century Communications. All right, the dummy has been pulled, the debris has been removed, and the Pioneer hung an effigy is no more. Pioneers bring it in off the faceoff. They have 30 seconds left on the power play. Tigers slow it behind the net, cleared up the far side, and the Pioneers don't keep it in. They have to retreat to their own end. As Newman picks it up, slides it right wing. They misfire. Elfring breaks it up, still in the neutral zone. Picked up by Gunther, now sent near side to Murphy. Ahead, but broken up by Johnson, and backhanded in deep by Darren Clark. 7 seconds left on the power play. Pioneers only 14% proficient on the power play on the road. Tigers aren't much better than that, but they have killed off the first penalty in a scoreless game with 8:31 left in the period, and now the Pioneers have iced the puck. We'll pause for a timeout and return. No score, 8:30 left in the first period. This is Tiger Hockey.
Before you remodel your kitchen or bathroom, visit the Elger Inside Out House at Rampart Plumbing and Heating Supply. From sinks to tubs and faucets, Elger makes it easy to find what you're looking for. Rampart Plumbing and Heating Supply at 110 West Vermejo, across from Chrissy Fowler Lumber. Rampart Plumbing and Heating Supply, a locally owned company since 1968.
Come on into the Inside Out House, Rampart Plumbing and Heating Supply.
We're back. Puck right point. Eric Reed tries to send it in. It drifts to neutral ice. Pioneers pick it up. This is Darren on the right wing. Centers. Man open. Rude breaks it up. Pokes it to the far boards. It drifts towards the corner. TJ Tanberg digs it out. Backhands it up the near side. Aaron Karpin cannot field it. It's kept in by Gavin Morgan. Now Karpin has him wrapped up. Tanberg comes in to help out. Now backs off. Four players in a scrum near side. KJ Voorhees frees it up. And he's going to skate through the corner. Parks it behind the net to Elfring, back to Voorhees, tries to clear it out, hits one of the Pioneers, and it's kept in. Then Tanberg dives to send it to neutral ice. Picked up there by Travis Smith, has to wait for his teammates to get back onside. Sends it behind the Tiger net. Picked up by Elfring. Elfring's lead pass comes off the stick of one of the Pioneers at neutral ice, backhanded back in. Grabbed by Anders Bjork, gets by Rood in the corner. Elfring kneels to try to break it up. The Pioneers can't go anywhere with it, but behind the net. Centering pass, man open, one-timer, over the crossbar, streaking from the backside for the Pioneers, and nearly putting it in was Joe Ritson. Now it's behind the net, pushed alongside the net, deflected over the net, far side. Tigers dig it out, head back the other way. Ian Peterson trying to slide it ahead to Bodker. Bodker's wrapped up Pioneers pick it up. Comrie brings it in. Wrist shot. Cugnet knocks it down. It drifts to the far corner. Tigers' Cal Elfring will get to it first. Elfring slides it to neutral ice. Had nobody to pass to. Back skating. It's picked up by the Pioneers' Kerlick. Sent to neutral ice. Grabbed by Eric Rude, waits for the Tigers to finish their line change. It's Toby Peterson, and he quickly whips it behind the DU net. Travis Shane frees it up, tipped off the puck in the corner. Pioneers pick it up, try to clear. Eric Anderson skates out of the zone, got Laxton on the right wing, brings it in, drop pass. Pioneers offside. So the Pioneers will be forced back outside the Tiger blue line for a faceoff. 6:33 left in the first period of play. If you are a Colorado College Tiger hockey season ticket holder, look in the mail soon for next year's package. They are going to start setting up a priority system for tickets that will put Colorado College both here at the Air Force Academy and at the Colorado Springs World Arena. If you want information on how this will be distributed to other hockey fans who are not season ticket holders, you can call Tiger Pride at 389-6336. Rest assured, there will be a priority system set up beginning with the season ticket holders, then the people who are contributors to the Colorado Springs World Arena, and then to the general public. Call Tiger Pride, 389-6336, and of course, continue to stay tuned to Sports Radio and KRDO TV 13. We'll be telling you about the plans to make priority reservations for tickets for next season for both the Air Force Academy and the new Colorado Springs World Arena. Tigers could open there in late January or the first week in February. If they open in the last week of January, it'll be Wisconsin. If they open in the first week of February, it'll be Denver. Here's a wrist shot by Eric Anderson, knocked down by Cugnet. Rebound by Anderson, knocked down. Tigers retrieve at far corner. Scott Swanson backhands it to Peters, back to Swanson. Forechecking by the Pioneers right now. Tigers' Darren Clark pushes it to neutral ice, but the Pioneers are on him right away. And then Brian Swanson steps in, but ends up pushing it back into his own zone. Swanson will circle the net, puts it on the left wing boards. Lead pass comes to Darren Clark from Peters. Clark back to Swanson, tips it into the corner. Tigers will make a change. Cryway, Swanson, and Clark will come off. And the Tigers send on Hartnell, Shane, and Johnny Austin. Pioneers bring it in, Laxton to Gunther. Gunther wants to go back to Laxton. The play is broken up, and then Laxton piles into Cugnet into the net, and Eric Rude is all over Laxton. And we've got Tempers, the first real flare-up tonight. Cugnet comes out, shakes out the locks, skates away from the fracas, and will retrieve his helmet momentarily. Let's see if we get coincidentals out of this. And maybe we can get a look at it and see if Laxton came in on his own, or if he had some help from one of the Tigers. Laxton, and or at least Root, is headed over to the penalty box. So Eric makes his second appearance of the period. It comes with 5:24 left, 14:36 in. And Laxton is also in the box for Denver. Now let's see, they've not posted the player or the time on the scoreboard yet for Laxton, so it's possible. Now they've taken both off the scoreboard. They've taken Root's penalty off the scoreboard as well. Now will there be a second penalty to Denver that Laxton's may be more severe? We'll just have to wait and see. We'll take a timeout here while they're sorting this out. Hopefully we'll have an answer for you on how they're setting this one up. The penalty door to the Denver booth is still open. We'll be back after this timeout. This is Tiger Hockey. I guess we'll keep it right here. I thought we were going to go to a break. We'll just keep it right here as we've seen a second player drift into the Denver penalty box. And here's the faceoff. It's won by the Pioneers. Tigers wind up with the puck. This is Scott Swanson. Swanson sends it ahead. It's picked up by Cryway. Kriway pokes it to neutral ice as it comes off his stick to Scott Swanson, up the far side to Brian Swanson. Steps around one man, tries to fight through the check, is pulled down, penalty coming to Denver. And now the Tigers, who were on the power play to begin with a 5-on-4, will now get a 5-on-3 for the second time tonight. And we will pause for another timeout and return. Tigers scoreless with Denver, another power play advantage when we come back.
Perfect for before or after the game, come to Giuseppe's for great homemade food. Try the spaghetti and savory chicken or one of the tangy rib specials. For home-cooked meals, even when you can't do the cooking, Giuseppe's, 10 South Sierra Madre.
American Association of Retired Persons volunteers provide free assistance to low or middle income taxpayers. The volunteers are trained to complete basic income tax forms and answer any questions. For more information, please give us a call at 475-0800.
5-on-3 for a minute 30 for the Tigers here. It's dumped in behind the Denver net. Pioneers clear up the far side. Travis Smith will try to get it out, and he does. Wraps it around Dan Peters. Tigers really need to take advantage of this, and Don Lucia is motioning to the Tigers to start rotating through the offensive zone when they get into it. Scott Swanson near side, up top to Brian. Tigers balance off, far side to Peters. Peters back to Brian Swanson, touch pass up top to Scott. Scott looks inside, takes the drive, deflected to the goal! The Tigers have scored! Scott Swanson through the slot, connects with Cam Kriway, and the Tigers take the first red light of the night. 1-0 over the Pioneers with 59 seconds left on the man advantage. They score on the 5-on-3 and lead 1-0 on a power play goal. And when we get the replay ready, we'll bring it to you. 15:37. Kriway off the stick of Scott Swanson. And the Tigers with the 1-0 lead. At least we believe that was where the deflection occurred. Faceoff will come at neutral ice to restart. Apparently we are not going to get a look, at least right now, at the replay, but we'll try to get it back for you when we can. Faceoff with the Tigers up 1-0. They still have a minute 17 on the next power play. Tigers have it. Toby Peterson, and it is indeed Kriway. Tigers bring it in. Toby Peterson down low. It's tipped away and cleared out. Brian Swanson gets an assist as well. But for Kriway, goal number 11 of the year. Scott Swanson with his 12th assist. And Brian Swanson with his 102nd career point and his 29th assist of the year. Tigers are in. Bodker, backhander to goal. Stu Bodker, a backhanded goal. Getting past Mullen. The Pioneers had no backside help. And the Tigers convert on back-to-back power plays and now have a 2-0 lead over the visiting Denver Pioneers. 3:50 remains in the period, and the Tigers are off and running here thanks to the power plays, and the crowd alive here tonight as well. Everybody in black and gold is standing as the Tigers have raced to a 2-0 lead. 16-10 in, Bodker with the goal. His 11th in his last 13 games, his 14th of the season. Pioneers with the puck. Trying to get out of the zone, intercepted and broken up, and it's kicked into the crowd far side. Toby Peterson picks up his 15th assist of the season, and Scott Swanson picks up his second assist of the game and his 13th of the year. So two power play goals. Tigers off and running here at the Cadet Ice Arena with 3 minutes and 33 seconds left in period number one. So the Pioneers, who George Gwozdecky admitted dug themselves a hole in Duluth last week by dropping two games, have now dug themselves a hole here in the season series with the Tigers, where a tie or a win gives the Tigers the season series victory. They keep the gold pan. And of course, pick 2 points up on the Pioneers in the standings.
Puck behind the Denver net. Pioneers clear up the near side, but they don't get out. Tigers forechecking, keeping it alive. It ricochets off the end boards down low, and finally, Garrett Bouzon gets on top of it. Pioneers are back. Lead pass to Eric Anderson. Poked off his stick by Scott Swanson. Pioneers keep it in at the point, and they look down low. Centering pass. Wide. Deflected through the zone. A nice attempt by Ryan Hacker. Puck in the slot. Pioneers are down low. Scott Swanson controls. Puts it up the far side. Dug out by Darren Clark. Tigers are back. Brian Swanson will try to play it off the near side boards. It drifts on net and is kicked up to neutral ice by Mullen. All the way into the Tiger end. Icing call is waved off with 2:48 to play. CC with the puck behind the net now. Paul Johnson to neutral ice to Brian Swanson. Touch pass to Ian Peterson. Peterson launches. Deflected in traffic. Drifts towards the net. Oh, Darren Clark splits through the defense. Tries to keep it alive. Tries to bring it to the near side. Pioneers finally take it away from him. But it's still in the Denver zone. Picked up by Ian Peterson. Shovels it ahead to Clark. Clark is wrapped up. Peterson will go dig it out. Brian Swanson breaks to the slot. Peterson can't deliver. Ian's on top of the puck. It comes free in the corner. Tigers just tenacious on the forecheck tonight to bottle up the Pioneers in their own end. Curlett comes back the other way. Long lead pass. Connects with Newman, who runs it into the near corner. Paul Johnson will be there first. Backhands it up the near side and to the point. Picked up by Stu Bodker. Racing gets in one-on-one against Petri Gunther as it poked off his stick. Picked up by Patterson. Far side to Corbett. Lead pass to Warren Smith is broken up by the Tigers. Bodker leaves it at the point for Toby Peterson. He launches. Mullen the save. Picked up far side by Bodker. No look behind the back through the end zone to Toby Peterson. Going to skate through the corner. Comes up near side. Looks at the net. All the way through the zone. Down low. Man open. Mullen's down. Shot deflected by Mullen. Big time save as he was down. Scrambles back to his feet. Bodker's on top of the puck. Ian Peterson steps in to try and free it up. And just as he does, Mike Schmidt blows the whistle and play is stopped. Mullen was down. Tigers tried to fire it. Bodker got the shot off, and Mullen left it his left knee pad and deflected the shot. Richard Quincy is back on the bench, but we have not seen Bob Needham return. So we don't know if Bob is through for the night or not, but we will try to get a look as the Tigers skate off after this period. 1:31 left, Tigers leading 2-0. Two power play goals in the span of 33 seconds. Bodker and Kreiway in the Tigers lead 2-0. Pioneers, right point, drive launch. Cole, the Pioneers launch from the right point and score. Jason Cugnet partially screened, but the Pioneers are on the board. They get one of the two goals back, and that was a rocket launch from the right point. So with 1:19 left, the Tigers give up a goal in the final 2 minutes. This one comes with 18:41 expired, and Denver's on the board with an even strength goal. And Jason Cugnet beaten for the first time tonight. So the desperate team, the more desperate of the two teams here tonight, registers late in the first period. And we'll get the numbers for you a little bit later here. Pioneers bring it in again at the left point. Bouzon looking down low. Tigers break it up. John Austin and then Travis Shane. Shane skates for the neutral zone. Comes in at the left point. Has it poked off his stick by Ryan Hacker. But he delivers a check so that Hartlow can get the puck centered just ahead of John Austin. Pioneers get it. Clear it out. Dump it the length of the ice. Cal Elfring gets there. Golfs it off the glass. It comes to neutral ice as we enter the final minute. It's an unassisted goal for Travis Smith. And for Smith, his second goal of the season. So the Pioneers get one back, puck free in the neutral zone. Rude sends it in, picked off by Curlick. Curlick runs it into the near corner. Comes behind the Tiger net, dug out by Elfring. Elfring tries to put his team in transition, turns it over, puts it right on the stick of Gavin Morgan, who sends it down low, broken up by Cugnet. Comes near side, off the near boards. Brian Swanson turns it over off the skate of Comrie. Now the Pioneers have something working, but Eric Rude steps in front of Comrie and intercepts the pass. Kreiway gets it out to Swanson. Tigers in 2-on-1. Swanson and Clark. Swanson looks in, shoots, save. Mullen, rebound loose, shot. Oh, and Kreiway couldn't quite get the lumber on it. It was picked off by Comrie as he was getting ready to fire, and Mullen is spared a third goal in the first period. Comrie gets in, gets past Peters, who wraps him up. Puck drifts behind the net. Period comes to an end. Tigers go to the dressing room with the lead. The score is 2-1. We'll be back to summarize after this timeout.
This is the city. Springs. My name is Friday. It was a cool, clear night on the city's east side. It could have been any night, except on this night, I was dispatched to investigate a domestic disturbance. I pulled up to the residence in question and witnessed two men arguing from both sides of a fence. Apparently, the fence was on the other's property, but both had made claim to it. I could see why. It was built by Academy Fence. Strong, durable, beautiful. I informed the two suspects that a fence has two sides, and that this fence built by Academy Fence could be shared equally. They agreed, and I returned to my beat. Case closed.
The facts speak for themselves. A fence built by Academy Fence offers both security and beauty to any property, and is available in wood, chain link, split rail, vinyl, and ornamental iron. Call Academy Fence for a free estimate, and see the difference that 25 years experience makes. 598-7650. For all your fencing needs, call Academy Fence. 598-7650.
Public notice this Friday and Saturday only.
It's a giant statewide factory authorized new truck and car disposal sale.
But it's not at a dealership.
It's on Sinton Road next to Sinton Dairy.
Over 1,000 new trucks and cars.
Reduced to factory invoice.
Ford,
Mitsubishi,
Isuzu,
Audi,
Suzuki,
Kia,
even Nissan.
Reduced to factory invoice.
New truck and car payments as low as $99 a month. 99!
Refinancing as low as 0%.
Or up to $2,500 cash back.
Plus, if you're looking for a four-wheel drive pickup or sport utility, buy now.
Over 500 trucks and sport utilities to choose from.
All in one location.
Reduced to factory invoice.
1,000 imports and domestics.
Reduced to factory invoice.
Invoices posted on the windshields for your inspection.
Payments from $99 a month.
Check the Gazette for details.
Come early. Be prepared to buy.
During this giant $10 million new truck and car disposal.
This Friday and Saturday.
On Sinton Road next to Sinton Dairy.
Don't miss it.
Dealer installed options, if any, at retail. Limited term with approved credit. 97 Nissan pickup number 00936 month lease. 1,500 cash or trade down plus first payment acquisition fee and refundable security deposit. Excludes supercabs, turbo diesels, and expedition.
Welcome back to the Cadet Ice Arena. Period number one is over. The Tigers have some good news with a 2-1 lead, but they may have some bad news in an injury that sent Bob Needham to the dressing room with trainer Richard Quincy about midway through the period. We have not seen Needham return to the ice, nor seen him dressed in street clothes, so we'll just have to wait and find out what's going on with the assistant captain from Quesnel, British Columbia. Tigers explosive in the first period, though it took a couple of penalties to get them on track. They had a 5-on-3 advantage on two occasions tonight, but on the second occasion they took advantage as Cam Cryway deflected a blast from just below the blue line in the high slot off the stick of Scott Swanson, set up by Brian Swanson for a 1-0 lead on the power play. And then on the ensuing power play, when the advantage went from 5-on-3 to 5-on-4, Stu Bodker raced in from the high slot, got a nice centering pass from Toby Peterson, led out of the zone by Scott Swanson. And Bodker, who now has a total of 11 goals in his last 13 games, finished off on Jim Mullen for a 2-0 lead. Pioneers got one back, though, an unassisted blast from the right point above the circle through traffic. That defenseman Travis Smith found the net for his second goal of the season, and at 1:19 in the period, the lead was reduced to 1 at 2-1. Saves in the period, and this is the telling story. The Tigers have outshot the Pioneers 3-1, 13 shots on net for the Tigers, 4 on goal for the Pioneers. The only thing that might be somewhat tenuous about that is that the Tigers only have a 2-1 lead with that dominance. Penalties in the period, the Tigers took 2 for 4 minutes. Both were to Eric Rude. The Pioneers took 5 penalties for 10 minutes, and that's why they're behind right now as the Tigers capitalize on the power play. We're going to take a timeout. When we come back, our Tiger profile from Whitney Electric, a conversation with Aaron Carpen. We'll be right back after this.
It's the number one cause of household electrical fires: improperly used extension cords. Don't gamble with your family's safety. Instead, consider these electrical safety tips from Whitney Electric. Check extension cords often for worn and frayed areas. If cords are worn to the touch, discontinue their use immediately. But the best electrical safety precaution is to add another receptacle in the area where the extension cord is being used. For a safe bet, call 473-4212 and connect with the winning team at Whitney Electric.
It's not the best rate, but not the best service. Come to City Line Mortgage.
This is Rob Myers of City Line Mortgage, proud sponsors of CC Tiger Hockey. If you're looking for competitive rates and the best service, give us a call at City Line Mortgage. But don't do it just yet. Stay tuned to your radio and keep supporting those Colorado College Tigers.
It's not the best rate, but not the best service. Come on in the City Line Mortgage.
Put some magic in your life.
Home lighting, where quality shines.
Discover a beautiful new way to light a room at Home Lighting, serving Colorado Springs for more than 44 years. Shop their wonderful selection of lamps and ceiling fans, and look to Home Lighting for lampshades and complete repair service, too. Home Lighting, downtown at 624 North Tejon.
Home Lighting, where quality shines through.
When selling property, look to Lovett & Associates for results. Lovett & Associates provide an excellent source of buyers moving into the Springs area and will get the highest dollar possible for your home. Lovett & Associates has a proven track record in home sales and are members of one of the largest relocation services. Let the highly trained staff at Lovett & Associates assist you in the sale of your home. For unparalleled service and home sale results, call Lovett & Associates at 392-9031, now celebrating their 30th year.
Well, things seem to be breaking the Tigers' way here as we come back to the Kinnett Ice Arena. While they have a 2-1 lead on Denver, Northern Michigan has defeated North Dakota 2-1, and we have just found out that Minnesota Duluth has a 6-3 lead on Minnesota, so the Tigers could catch Minnesota for second tonight and be within 3 points of first place North Dakota with a victory here against the Pioneers. Time now for our Whitney Electric Tiger profile, and we're going to speak with Aaron Karpin. He's battled all those freshman hurdles, the books, life on campus, the speed of the game, and scoring. And he's won all of those battles with the exception of the scoring. Now, just like Whitney Electric, he comes to play every day and bring the power to the Tiger hockey program. But he knows that he's a little frustrated now, but the goals eventually will come.
Well, I don't know. My role on the team isn't really to score goals. I'll leave that to the older guys. It's getting on me. It's been a long time, but it'll come, and hopefully when it comes, it'll be at a key time in a game. So.
Well, and your chances have certainly been there, and I know that you work extremely hard. Is that what has kept you at least at a point where you're not pressing and that you are being patient?
Well, I guess so. It's frustrating, and I just try to keep working. I've had so many chances. A lot of guys have set me up, and I don't know, just for some reason, it just won't go. The puck won't go in, and it's frustrating, but I can't concentrate on that. My role on this team is more of a defensive role anyways, for now, being a freshman, so, it'll come eventually, and when it does, I'll be happy.
Well, when you have some players that are banged up, sometimes there is a little more pressure on those that are getting the regular shifts, whether their role as a defense or not. Do you feel like you need to?
Yeah, all lines got to contribute. We got a lot of key players in the lineup right now. Some of the guys got to step it up. We don't have Goodmanson, who's one of our top goal scorers right now. So, the guys that haven't been scoring all year have to come, and they gotta contribute for us to be successful.
Are you feeling and sensing the games being more and more meaningful each week out compared to when we talked early in the season?
Yeah, you look at our schedule now, St. Cloud, Minnesota, all those teams, we got to beat them to be higher in standings than them. So, every weekend's a big game, and they're all the games are big games in college, but especially now.
Some of the veteran players have said this team is now starting to come together, not just mechanically, but emotionally as well, where the wins really bring excitement and the losses really hurt and cause some depression.
I think that's a sign of a good team as well. You gotta have the team chemistry, and I think it's coming around now. We had a little lapse maybe earlier in the season, but things are coming well. We played a good 2-2 game against Minnesota Duluth. Unfortunately, second game, we couldn't get enough by their goaltender, who played very well. So things are coming together, and this team's starting to really hate to lose, which is a good thing.
And along those lines, when we talked earlier in the season, you were coming to a club that knew nothing but championships. And for the first time in 3.5 years, this team is not a consensus top 10 ranked team. Does that appeal to your pride as a player, Aaron?
I think it's more motivation than anything. But we hold our own destiny, so it's up to us.
What is more important, getting better week to week and handling the pressure of the stretch run, or really being worried about what the opponent has to offer?
I think it's more just week to week. All the games are big, and just got to concentrate on our opponent at hand and not worry about who we got next weekend, just worry about this weekend.
That's Aaron Karpin, freshman forward, and another case of a freshman who, as you can hear, in his comments, really places overall team mission above his own personal achievement. It's our Whitney Electric Tiger profile for the first intermission. Whitney Electric teaming with Tiger Hockey to bring the power of both fun and entertainment to the Pikes Peak region in our community. And the second period is where we're headed after we pause for this timeout.
April 15th is just around the corner. Are you still stalling? Well, relax. Here's a way to get those tax returns in on time, quickly, thoroughly, and inexpensively. I'm talking about TurboTax, a revolutionary software program from the makers of Quicken, guaranteed to make doing your taxes fast and hassle-free, or your money back. Just load TurboTax into your computer, answer a series of simple questions, and let TurboTax do the rest. TurboTax reviews your return, double-checks for errors and missing information. It even raises audit flags on questionable items. When complete, you just print out your return, sign, and mail. The job is done. Call 1-800-462-2112. Through this special radio offer, you can try TurboTax risk-free for 30 days. Keep it and pay just $39.95 plus $5 shipping. Call right now and you'll also receive Rand McNally's TripMaker 96 software free. So call 1-800-462-2112. Stop stalling. Call TurboTax now. 1-800-462-2112.
Cub Foods and Coca-Cola are proud to sponsor CC Tiger Hockey and can help you save on your overall food bill with everyday savings. Because Cub Foods buys in quantities big enough to demand huge discounts from suppliers, you'll save on more than 25,000 name-brand products store-wide, like Coca-Cola products. Pick up 12 packs of your thirst-quenching favorites for just $2.68. Visit any Colorado Springs Cub Foods today and join the savings celebration. Cub Foods, lower prices every aisle, every shelf, every day. Cub Foods, the Spendless Store.
When selling property, look to Lovett and Associates for results. Lovett and Associates provide an excellent source of buyers moving into the Springs area and will get the highest dollar possible for your home. Lovett and Associates has a proven track record in home sales and are members of one of the largest relocation services. Let the highly trained staff at Lovett and Associates assist you in the sale of your home. For unparalleled service and home sale results, call Lovett and Associates at 392-9031. Now celebrating their 30th year.
We are back at the Cadet Ice Arena. Both teams have returned to the ice, or at least the Pioneers are about ready to step onto the ice. And we have not seen Bob Needham. Oh, he has just stepped back on the ice. That's a good sign. The assistant captain of the Tigers is circling the net at the south end and has come back out on the ice. So it looks like Bob Needham is ready to go. We're going to take a look at a couple of highlights from the first period. There's a look at Needham, who's just returned to the ice. Watch Scott Swanson take the drive. Cam Crywee deflects it past Mullen. And that's the 1-0 Colorado College lead. Then the second goal comes as you see the Tigers break it in on the right wing, and a centering pass from Toby Peterson to a wide open Stu Bodker, who chipped it backhand over the shoulder of Jim Mullen. And no backside help for Mullen that time, as Bodker found the open area and brought it home. And now the goal scored by the Denver Pioneers, and watch it be brought to the point, and Travis Smith just launches here. Jason Cugnett partially screened, and he's beaten cleanly. An unassisted goal for Travis Smith. And a good sign to see Bob Needham back out on the ice. They need his help on defense. All right, we're going to update you around the WCHA as we get ready for the start of period number two at Mariucci Arena in the Twin Cities. 6-4, Duluth leads Minnesota. It's in the third period. Northern Michigan, of course, has beaten North Dakota, the Northern Michigan Wildcats, with a huge victory. That helps CC, helps Denver as well. Could have helped Minnesota, but the Gophers are struggling with Duluth. St. Cloud leads Wisconsin 2-0 after one period of play, and Michigan Tech has defeated Anchorage by a score of 4-3. So the bottom three have all done well tonight, with the exception of Anchorage, which lost at Michigan Tech. We're underway, second period is now a go, and the puck is free at neutral ice. Tigers will be skating right to left across your radio dial and your television screen. Here's a wrist shot by Eric Anderson that's deflected by Darren Clark to the far corner, drifts behind the Tiger net, picked up by Crywee, doesn't do anything with it, and Brian Swanson takes a drive on his shin or his ankle and is coming off early on this shift. He could not pursue the puck where he might be able to get a breakaway. He's coming off the ice. Pioneers clear, and they bring it in. This is Anderson, bottled up, centers, but Toby Peterson takes it away, got a whistle, and the Tigers taking a penalty here. We're getting a slashing call, and I believe so. The Tigers are getting hit with a penalty to start the second period, and this is Crywee, maybe a little bit out of frustration from not being able to bang home a goal here in the early going of this period. But Cam Kreiway goes to the penalty box for CC, 19-28 left in the period, just 32 seconds in. The Tigers commit an infraction. Slashing call, 2-minute minor, and the second power play chance of the night for the Pioneers. Faceoff will be in the near circle, but at its outer rim away from the net. Elfring picks up the puck off the faceoff and scoots it off the boards the length of the ice. It'll come out of the corner, played by Mullen. Bodker is there, chips it off his stick and into the protective netting. And that means a faceoff in the Denver zone. So Stu Bodker, just with a little additional hustle, brings the play back into the Denver zone. Brian Swanson still trying to work off that shot on his, either his shin or his ankle, off that shot from the left point that ricocheted into the Denver zone. There's Stu Bodker, big backhand goal, and he's hot right now. Tigers win the faceoff, and Toby Peterson, a quick wrist shot, nearly makes it a 3-1 game with a shorthanded goal. Peterson fighting for it in the corner. Now it's finally picked up by the Pioneers. Joe Ritson sends it the length of the ice. The icing call is waved off. Elfring digs it out, sends it up the near side, but it comes right to Eric Anderson quickly. Bodker gets on him. Now in the corner to Laaksonen. Near side to Comrie, the leading scorer. Up top to Petri Guthrie, back to Comrie. Tigers break it up, clear it out, but it's fielded in neutral ice by Ritson. To Gunther, to Comrie, and back to Ritson. Ritson is dogged by Brian Swanson, who's back on the ice, and now Swanson forces the Pioneers back into their own zone. Eyes pick it up, bring it in at the right point. Antti Laaksonen, drop pass for Eric Anderson. Drop pass for Comrie, marching to the net. Wrist shot, save Cudnan. Rebound loose, chipped towards the net, and deflected off a Tiger's stick to the near side. Well, Cudnan was left hung out to dry, but the puck deflects to the protective netting and play stops. We'll take our first timeout of the second period. Tigers lead it 2-1. DU power play continues when we come back.
We've been in our house for about 12 years.
Yeah, it was time to change the carpet.
Hi, Bob Beeler with another comforting carpet story from Sears.
We didn't want to make any mistakes. Sears did everything possible to make us comfortable.
Tell me about Sears' premier installation package.
Sears moved the furniture, picked up the old carpet, put down the new carpet. What's a new living room?
That's comforting to hear. And so is all carpet on sale at Sears. Every beautiful yard on sale through Saturday. Sale excludes buyer's best buys. Sears, where the experience is as comfortable as the carpet.
Puck loose in the faceoff circle, drifts to the point. Pioneers try to keep it in. Comes to the near corner, backhanded behind the net by Patterson. Needham in pursuit, but the Pioneers' Murphy keeps it alive over there. Now Needham picks it up, drills it up the near side. Warren Smith can't keep it in, but it is kept in by Newman, who lets fly a drive, broken up by Brian Swanson. Picked up by Comrie in the corner to Patterson, behind the net to Anders Bjork. York brings it to the point. Pioneers wind up, bring it near side. Newman looks down low, comes to Comrie. Comrie brings it up top. Newman launches, deflected by a diving Darren Clark. It drifts to the far point. Pioneers keep it in. 24 seconds left on the power play. Wrist shot. Comrie knocked down in traffic. That one caught Scott Swanson in the chest. It's loose. Shot. Cutman covers up in front. Oh, Scott Swanson took one in the chest. And then Patterson moved to the net, and Cugnet dove out and covered up to prevent goal number two and the Tigers' first power play game goal allowed in seven games. And now you see Chris Shook, the assistant referee, taking the puck out of Cugnet's glove. Good look at Dan Peters and the captain, Eric Rude. Going to take a look on the replay here as it comes to the point. Comrie winds up, caught Scott Swanson. Patterson right there for the rebound. Scott Swanson protects the puck before the Pioneers free it up, bring it back on the doorstep, and then Patterson fires again, and Cugnet covers it up. Excellent play by the Tigers, and Scott Swanson, who I know was hurting with that puck in the midsection, still sacrificed his body to keep the puck from drifting towards Cugnet. Pioneers keep it in at the point. 10 seconds left on the power play. Eyes want to run it in deep. Finally, they do. It's intercepted in front of the net by Rude. Rude sends it up the far side, finds an alley, and gets it out the length of the ice. Penalties expire. Puck behind the net. Comes near side. Push to the point. Tigers keep it in. Austin looks down low. It's deflected. Petri Gunther picks it up. Circles the far corner. Brings it to the far side boards. Tigers backhand it down low. Deflected. Mullen has to cover up. That one fooled him. Backhanded from the right point by Eric Rude, and Mullen had to fiddle with it before he covered up. Another overflow crowd here tonight at the Cadet Ice Arena as you get a look at Travis Shane, who had a big goal in the Tigers' Saturday night victory over Wisconsin. Travis, of course, plays awfully well on the road. Better than 85% of his points come on the road. Faceoff will evolve in the Denver zone, far circle. Toby Peterson against Gavin Morgan. And we got a whistle. And Tim Switer says that the Tiger and Pioneer camped out on the far side of the circle. Ian Peterson and Ryan Hacker are encroaching, so they back them up. Dig it out in the corner off the faceoff. Picked up by Travis Smith, who has Denver's only goal. He pushes the Pioneers out. Coming in high, still stick handling. Pulls up at the point, wants to send it down low. Intercepted by Paul Johnson. Tries to send it ahead. Comes to Toby Peterson. Oh, broken up by Travis Smith. Tigers would have had a 3-on-2. Pioneers are back in. Morgan, drop pass. Looking in the slot. Ian Peterson breaks it up. It goes far corner. Still in the Tiger zone. Elfring picks it up. Wraps it around one Pioneer to Ian Peterson. Shovels it ahead to his brother Toby. Toby's coming in 1-on-1 with Hacker. Gets around him. Gets in. But can't get much muscle on the shot. And he's taken into the boards. Stu Botker digs it out in the corner. Three players right there in front of our end zone camera. You see the battle that goes on. It's just this side of Mortal Kombat, this game, when you're in the corners. Toby Peterson centers Ian. Save Mullen racing in. Penalty coming to Denver. Trying to make the rebound goal is Ian Peterson. And Mullen covers up, but a cross-checking call is coming to the Pioneers. And the hard work out of the corner by CC draws a penalty, and the Tigers will get the man advantage. And we'll come back for that power play. Tigers lead it 2-1. We'll take this timeout and return. This is Tiger Hockey.
Can I open another bag of Doritos, Mom?
Another one? I don't know.
Use the Force, Luke.
I should open more Doritos, Mom.
Why don't you open more Doritos, dear?
The Star Wars trilogy is back on the big screen. Celebrate its return with Star Wars 3D motion cards and discs in specially marked bags of Doritos tortilla chips. Collect all your favorite moments.
I should have a car, Mom.
Don't push it, Luke. Yoda and I are like this.
Oh.
Star Wars and Doritos. The adventures never end. Limited time only.
Faceoff will come far circle in the Denver zone. And it'll be Brian Swanson stepping in against Denver's James Patterson. Voorhees tips it to the point to Scott Swanson. Far side to Darren Clark. Down in the corner to Brian. Tigers center. Oh, K.J. Voorhees was set up beautifully. Scuffed the shot. Pioneers get to the point and out. Along the near board, Scott Swanson sweeps it ahead to Voorhees. Voorhees slides it across to a streaking Darren Clark. In at the right point, one-on-one with Perlick. Gets inside as it poked off his stick. And it's gathered in by the Pioneers, who dump it the length of the ice. Darren Clark thought he might have an avenue to the net. Dan Peters picks it up behind the Tiger net. Brings it up across his blue line to Scott Swanson. Lets it drift off his stick into the zone. Picked up by Curlick, and as he tries to send it out, it catches the protective netting with 1:22 left on the man advantage. Tigers with a 2-1 lead here, and things breaking their way around the WCHA. We hope to have a final here before too long on Minnesota and Minnesota Duluth. The Gophers rushed off to a 3-1 lead at Mariucci. Three unanswered goals, though, by Duluth. Actually, they sprung that into a 5 unanswered goal run for a 6-3 lead at 6-4 late in the third period. And of course, we'll have that score for you as soon as possible. For if the Gophers were to lose and the Tigers to win, CC's in a tie for second, 3 points behind North Dakota, which was upset tonight at Lakeview in Marquette, Michigan by Northern Michigan. Drive into the corner by Elfring hits Mike Schmidt. So the Pioneers get to it easily, send it back into the Tiger zone. Schmidt's got to learn to duck for those low bridges. Up the near side it comes. In comes Elfring. Looks down low. Centers just missed Botford. Comes to the point and Rude keeps it in. Sends it into the corner. Toby Peterson lets it drift behind the net. Botker goes to dig it out and sends it right back to Toby. Up top to Rude. Rude's going to slide it near side to Elfring and back to the captain far side. Now to the far boards of Toby Peterson. Looks inside. No look behind the back to Johnny Austin. Circling out of the corner. Up top to Rude. One-timer. Deflected. It goes into the corner. Anderson's after it. Scuffs the clearing effort picked up by Bodker. Tigers still have 34 seconds left. Bodker to the point to Elfring, and then Cal can't hang on. Tigers were really circling the Denver net, and an opportunity to build on the lead here goes awry. 22 seconds left on the power play as Elfring sends it back in. Into the corner goes Swanson and Clark. It comes free along the far boards, and then a diving effort by the Pioneers. Kerlick gets it back to the Tiger blue line. Elfring picks it up, runs it ahead to K.J. Voorhees, playing along the near board, slides it through, open is Rude, Rashad, save Mullen, and the rebound swept quickly behind the net by Eric Anderson. Tigers dig it out, penalty's over. Swanson in the corner, no look behind the back towards the net, hoping to catch Clark breaking from the corner, but Clark was not breaking. Pioneers send it the length of the ice, Cugman steers it up the near side, controlled by Scott Swanson, shoves it ahead, but too far ahead of K.J. Voorhees, fielded by Ritson, sent up the near side. Tigers intercept easily. Brian Swanson trying to advance it is wrapped up. Scott Swanson pushes it ahead, intercepted by Corbett and sent to the Zamboni corner, Tiger end. Rude picks it up, wants to clear it out. He's bottled up, kicks it ahead to Scott Swanson. Swanson backhands it to Voorhees. Voorhees is going to try to clear it to the blue line. Pioneers keep it in, send it high through the slot to the corner. Pioneers after it. Two Tigers tied up in the corner and they launch from the point and Corbett shot. He had a good look at Cugnet, but he launched it too high and it catches the protective net and play stops. 13:30 left in period number two. Again, Tiger pride is a terrific way, even at this late stage of the season, to get involved in all the activity surrounding Colorado College athletics. All it takes is a $35 membership fee. Not only do you have the privilege of getting connected with Tiger Athletics and their coaches, but use of the Hahn and Ice Center and the Schlesman Pool are available to you at designated times free of charge. You get discounts on some of the Tiger Pride functions. Next week, Doug Woog and Don Lucia at Carrabba's at the south end of town near the Red Lion. 12 noon, make your reservations by calling 389-6336. 389-6336, that's Tiger Pride. Pioneers have it in the Tiger zone. Aaron Carpen sweeps it away, retrieves it to Travis Shane, bottled up and squirts free in the corner. Newman tries to center. He's wrapped up by Bob Needham. Now works through the check, back through the corner to Warren Smith. He evades Carpen, and then Carpen picks his pocket. Carpen's headed the other way. Backhands it to the point. Pioneers keep it in. Wrist shot. Knocked down in traffic by Needham. And the Tigers are back 3-on-2 in transition. Travis Shane at the point. Looks inside. Fires, deflected, off the glass, far side. Carpen tries to dig it out. It's picked up and brought to the point. Kept in by the Tigers. Sent down low. Pioneers break it up, and oh, they're back 2-on-1. 3-on-1 if they're quick. Hacker launches. Cutting it the save. Rebound swept near side by Elfring. Tigers pick it up in the corner. Good play by Cugnet to keep the Pioneers from tying the game. Lead pass for Travis Shane is long. Tigers will get hit with an icing call here. With 12:24 remaining, Tigers needed the change. It was the long shift. So a face-off back in the Tiger zone when we return. We'll be back after this timeout. Tigers 2, Pioneers 1.
Honey, I'm sorry.
You can fix it. Over a candlelight dinner at the Briarhurst. Entrees start at 10:50. The food's delicious. Service is great. The atmosphere is comfortable and quiet, so you can talk over a great meal. The Briarhurst, the perfect place to get away for a couple of hours of quality time. Enjoy each other's company. It's an investment in your relationship.
We are back. Face-off will come in the Colorado College end near circle. Toby Peterson, Ian Peterson, and Stu Bodker playing together tonight. And Toby will look to win the draw from Eric Anderson. And he's playing with Antti Laaksonen and Joe Murphy. Laaksonen wins the draw, comes near side, poked around Rude. Bodker backhands it to the blue line, kept in by Petri Gunther. Bodker fields it along the near side, behind the net to Elfring. Slides it up the far side. Bodker has it, tries to get out. It's poked off his stick. Pioneers still have it. Drive from the point. Cugnet kicks it out. Retrieved by Murphy. Turn around towards the slot. Broken up by Rude. Rude kicks it ahead. Toby Peterson winds up with it. Then Bodker, but taken away by Laaksonen. In the corner, centering pass. Laaksonen streaking. Wrist shot. Deflected by the Tigers in traffic. Laaksonen fields it in the corner. Wraparound attempt. Save. Rebound. Goal. The Pioneers are even. A rebound goal for Joe Murphy. But Antti Laaksonen made that goal. Circled the net. Drew Cugnet's attention. The rebound came right to the slot to Murphy, who beat Cugnet cleanly. And now we're tied at two apiece. 11:48 remaining. And you'll see on the replay that Cugnet did get a lot of help out front, but Antti Laaksonen, when he gets untracked, can make life extremely miserable for any defense. And the Pioneers, who were victims of two power play goals earlier, now have scratched and clawed their way back into it on an even strength goal by Joe Murphy from Antti Laaksonen. 11:48 in, remaining in the period, 8:12 into the game for the second period. For Murphy, his seventh goal of the season, and for Laaksonen, his 13th assist.
And number six, Ryan Hacker
is also being given an assist. The Pioneers are back in again. Tigers have to fight from behind their own net. Oh, Brian Swanson nearly brought it in front of the net. Poked off his stick. Pioneers buzzing again. Puck loose in the slot, controlled by Darren Clark, and the Tigers will get out of danger. As the Tigers bring it in, they want a center. Clark goes down, retrieves, center's man open. Tanberg fans on the one-timer. Clark had him set up beautifully. Picked up by Brian Swanson in the corner, up along the far side boards. At the point, backhands it. Pioneers break it up, scoot it out of the zone. Lead pass, gets past Dan Peters, drifts to the near corner. Pioneers make a change and an icing call on the DU Pioneers. So, after a 2-0 start, the Pioneers have two unanswered goals, and we're going to see Antti Laaksonen at his best here. Watch him come out of the corner, steps around Toby Peterson. Unmolested to the near side, Cut makes the save, and all alone is Murphy in front of the net. Bang. Anybody's going to cash in on that kind of a chance. And Murphy did just that. So Murphy left alone in the slot, and the shot pays off. Tigers have it in the high slot. Pioneers break it up and scoots near side. Push to neutralize. Looking to dig it out is John Austin. Pushed off his stick. Patterson tries to push it past Needham, but Needham gets it ahead to Shane, who tips it to neutralize. Travis Smith picks it up, goes into the Tiger end, and another icing call, this time against the DU Pioneers. Same two teams tomorrow night, but the scene shifts to Denver, where the Tigers have won their last two meetings. The second meeting in Denver last year and the first meeting this year, all part of five straight wins for the Tigers, but right now that streak is somewhat in peril as the teams are tied at two goals apiece. To the point, Elfring fires, broken up by the Pioneer defense. Tigers try to keep it alive. Travis Shane retrieves the puck, but he has to go back to neutral ice, and then he tries to hit the captain, and Root can't field it. It goes into the Zamboni corner. Hartnell tries to push it out. Kept in, one-timer, whistles wide off the end boards. Grabbed by Comrie, centering pass deflected. Cugnet at the point. Gunther looks inside, marches to the net. He's got an alley. Tigers are standing around watching. Gunther's going to circle from the other side. Wrist shot, save Cugnet. Puck loose. Centered, broken up. Comes to the near corner. Tigers are really standing around watching the Pioneers circle their zone. York picks it up, circles the net, wrapped up by Elfring, dishes far side, Hartnell breaks it up, pushes it around one man, tries to retrieve it, he does, tries to hit Travis Shane, he does, Shane brings it in, one-on-one with Corbett, wheels, waits for help to come as the line change is made, holds the puck up with his big strong body in the corner, Tigers dig it out, now KJ Voorhees in trying to center as it taken off his stick, Pioneers break, ahead for Charlie Host, he can't get to it, fielded by Scott Swanson. Swanson runs it ahead to Needham, and Needham runs it deep. After it goes Paul Johnson, held up by Corbett. Tries to center, comes free in the corner. Puck is dug out along the near boards by Aaron Carpet. Wants to center, has to push it behind the net. Johnson's going to dig it out, going to bring it up the far side, then lifts it back into the corner. Pioneers pick it up, try to clear it. Comes to the point, Scott Swanson keeps it in. To Carpet in the corner, back to Scott Swanson. Sends it back to Carpet, crashing out of the corner, behind the net. Carpet keeps it alive to Voorhees, fans on the shot, puck loose. Pioneers pick it up, and Newman tries to clear it out, and it hits the protective netting. So play stops with 9:04 left in the second period. We're in a 2-2 dead heat here at the Cadet Ice Arena, and should you expect any more, when these two clubs get together, the DU Pioneers and the Colorado College Tigers. And of course, we're proud to bring it to you on Sports Radio, AM 1240. KRDO Radio, Colorado Springs, Colorado, and on cable channel 70 from KRDO TV 13 and Century Communications. Faceoff far circle, Denver zone, right on the center dot. Brian Swanson Wins the draw, comes to the point to Needham, looks to take the wrist shot, now sends it down low, pushed on Mullen, rebound in the slot, swept away by Eric Anderson. Sends it up the far side. Pushed to neutral ice by Curlin. Pioneers pick it up there to Anderson. Now a touch pass to Antti Laaksonen, and gets around Scott Swanson. He's coming out of the corner again, but this time Swanson hips him off the puck. Anderson waits for it, goes to the corner, comes behind the net to Murphy. Murphy wants to center. He does. Oh, and it's deflected by Antti Laaksonen, and he should have had his second of the night. Tigers dodge a bullet. Lead pass to Brian Swanson. Leaves it for Darren Clark. Clark sends it ahead after he's hipped off the puck. Brian picks it up. Left circle. Wrist shot nearly fooled Mullen. He wrapped it between the legs of the Pioneers freshman defenseman Joe Ritson and nearly surprised goaltender Jim Mullins. Play stops with 8:22 remaining in the period. Teams change up. Out comes Peterson and Bodker for the Tigers. And for the Pioneers, Darren Bouzon and Gavin Morgan. Toby Peterson will look to win the draw. You look at his brother Ian. Ian had a terrific goal at Wisconsin last week, crashing in from the left point, launched the shot. Dobinspeck made the save, and Ian, as he told me, as he's taught way back in Bantams and Pee-wees, follow your shot. The rebound came back to him, and he beat Dobinspeck on the second try. Toby wins the draw to Dan Peters. He's going to launch through traffic. Ooh, that one nearly found the upper right-hand corner. In fact, Mullen is still looking for the puck. It's gone into the protective netting. And play stops for another faceoff with 8:18 left in the period. We'll be on the air tomorrow night from Denver on Sports Radio at 6:45. We are not televising from the Denver area, so we hope you'll make plans to join us here on Sports Radio, AM 1240. Toby Peterson wins the drive at the Pioneers. Ryan Hacker comes up with the puck. Sends it near corner to Travis Smith. Up the right wing boards to Mike Darren. Darren left wing. Comes off the skate of Bodker into the Zamboni corner. Bodker will pat it behind the net. Near side to Dan Peters. Lead pass connected to Toby Peterson. Right wing to Bodker in front of the Pioneer bench. Comes in one-on-one with Hacker. Tries to fight through the check. Can't do it as he's held up. Travis Smith gets to it. Sends it behind the net. Ian Peterson in pursuit, but the Pioneers pick it up. Try to bring it to neutral ice, and then it's swatted by Gavin Morgan into the corner, and the Pioneers are guilty of icing. So we'll take a timeout and come back. 2-2 tie here at the Cadet Ice Arena. This is Tiger Hockey.
What you're about to hear can help save your life. You can count on Genuine Bayer Aspirin to relieve everyday pain. But if you think all leading pain relievers are the same, Genuine Bayer Aspirin can do something Tylenol and Advil can't. Only Genuine Bayer Aspirin can reduce the risk of another heart attack by up to 50% when taken regularly with a diet and exercise regimen. Ask your doctor and use only as directed. There's also Extra Strength Bayer. Nothing stronger on everyday pain. Bayer. Powerful pain relief and so much more.
Puck in the far corner, frozen to the boards in the Denver zone. Squirts free. Now back into the corner, backhanded behind the net. Tigers nearly intercept. Pioneers try to clear. Kept in by Eric Rude. Runs it right back in the corner looking for Hartnell. Pioneers get there first. Then John Austin takes it away to Travis Shane. Looks inside. A little late trying to catch a streaking Hartnell, but Shane continues to battle in the end zone. Working hard. Pinned to the boards. Gets some help from John Austin now. And Shane working against Petri Gunther. Austin coming in with Corbett draped all over him. And then finally it's picked off by the Pioneers. And out of the zone comes Anders Bjork to Paul Comrie, and the Pioneers are back 3-on-2. Drop pass, man open, wrist shot, Cugnet, the blocker stop. Robbing Bjork, Tigers get out. The Paul Johnson can't field the pass. It goes high into the Denver zone. Paul in pursuit, fighting through a check, but coming back the other way is Kurlick. Kurlick comes in at the right point, works down low, hipped off the puck by Elfrin. Comrie picks it up, wants to center, wrapped up by Johnson. Now it's picked up by Warren Smith, wants to center, knocked down and intercepted by Aaron Carpen, backhands it over the far dashers into the penalty box, and Marty Scarano, the Colorado College Athletic Director, fields the puck and hands it back to the officials. Got a final score out of the Twin Cities. Minnesota Duluth has helped the Tigers with an explosive 8-4 victory over the Minnesota Gophers, who have now lost 3 of their last 5 games. Now that's going to juice up the Pioneers too, because the University of Denver knows a loss to the Tigers means they fall to 7th behind Duluth. So as those scores start being announced in this building, the intensity will pick up even more. In the corner, Bob Needham intercepts a pass off the far boards. Lead pass to Johnson, tips it into the Denver zone, in pursuit, digs it out behind the net, tries to center, but overskating it is K.J. Voorhees. Johnson digs it out again in the corner, sends it behind the net up the far side. Looking for it are the Tigers. Needham keeps it alive, sends it towards the corner. Pioneers intercept, and they get back, and they're getting back 3-on-2. Right wing pass broken up, puck in the high slot. Voorhees sweeps it away, sends it off the glass into the Denver zone. It comes off a support in the penalty box area between the Tiger bench and the penalty box, and play is stopped. That's out of play. So a faceoff will take place at neutral ice. At least that's where it should be. When we get back to action with 5:55 remaining in period number two. So with both North Dakota and Minnesota losing tonight, the Tigers have a gift wrap 2 points. They can tie for second, pull within three of first. And let's see if they can overcome this Denver team, which has two unanswered goals of their own here now. Cam Cryaway waiting for the faceoff at center ice. Brian Swanson looking to win the draw as Cryaway balances off and the puck goes deep into the Denver zone. Travis Smith behind the Denver net. Looks up ice, puts it on the left wing. Pioneers try to get it out. It's deflected by Cryway. It drifts to the high portion of the Tiger zone. Scott Swanson picks it up, cross ice to Needham. Slaps it off the boards. Smith sends it right back in. Off the end boards, it comes to Scott Swanson behind the Tiger net. Pioneers set up their forecheck. Tigers balancing off, trying to fill the passing lanes. Long pass by Cryway. Didn't see it coming. Picked up by Hatcher. Sends it off to neutralize. Tigers strip it hard. Up behind the net, driven up the near side, pushed to neutral ice. Well, it hits a glass support, it stays in the Denver zone. Now it's kicked to neutral ice. Grabbed by Peter. Peter sends it ahead to Ian Peterson. Poked off his stick, he retrieves it. Then the Pioneers take it away, send it in and cut. He picks it up, kick it off the far court. Pioneers design, keeps it in. Runs it into the corner, waiting for Morgan. Centering pass, picked up by Comrie. Gets around one man, sets up, broken up by Toby Peterson. And Peterson's breaking away! He's accelerating! He's going! He's going! He's going! Toby Peterson! Oh, what a breakaway! He created it himself, and he puts it away, and this crowd comes to life. The Tigers beat Jim Mullen for goal number three, and with 4:10 left in the period, have the...
I am a non-smoker, a nicotine-free man. I haven't had a cigarette in 6 months or a piece of Nicorette gum in 3. Nicorette helped me get off cigarettes my way. It eased me down, one craving at a time. I needed less and less and less Nicorette until I needed none. And none is a wonderful number.
Nicorette gum will help you quit smoking successfully by helping you control your cravings. You can do it. Nicorette can help. Use as directed.
We are back, puck at neutral ice. Pioneers with the puck. And they're heading into the Tiger zone. Sent up the near side. Pioneers in the corner, centering pass, they misfire. Tigers kick it out. Here comes Stu Bodker back the other way. At the left point, pulls up, has it poked off his stick. Pioneers carry it to the far corner. Dug out in the far corner and pushed to neutral ice. Pioneers try to bring it in, and it is sent in. Toby Peterson's goal, as we mentioned, unassisted, and it comes at 15:50 into the period. Puck in front of the Tiger bench. Pioneers try to dump it in, and they do. Sent into the far corner. After it is Danny Peters. Peters behind the net. Sends it ahead. Connects with John Austin. Touch past Ian Peterson. Back to Austin. Runs it around Travis Smith to the far side boards. Dug out by Ryan Hacker, sends it up the near side, picked off by Warren Smith, and then Elfring takes it away from Smith. Ahead to Hartnell, it drifts into the Denver zone. 3:02 left in the period. Pioneers bring it to their own blue line. They lose it. Picked up by Hartnell, has to wait for his teammates to get back on side, and then he fans on the lead pass back into the zone. Travis Shane keeps it alive, though, and outmuscles Warren Smith for the puck. Dumps it into the far corner and goes in pursuit. Pioneers clear it out. This one's coming the length of the ice, and an icing call on the Pioneers. We'll pause for 30 seconds and return. Tigers back on top, 3-2.
It's the number one cause of household electrical fires. Improperly used extension cords. Don't gamble with your family's safety. Instead, consider these electrical safety tips from Whitney Electric. Check extension cords often for worn and frayed areas. If cords are worn to the touch, discontinue their use immediately. But the best electrical safety precaution is to add another receptacle in the area where the extension cord is being used. For a safe bet, call 473-4212 and connect with the winning team at Whitney Electric.
We are back. Tigers with a 3-2 lead as we get ready for a face-off in the Denver zone. Tigers put an end to the two-goal unanswered run by the Denver Pioneers. Toby Peterson, as we mentioned, picking up goal number 10 of the season. We're going to see the breakaway. Just watch him accelerate here. And when he gets inside, he puts it away as he drew Mullen out of the net, goes to the left-hand side of the net, and the Tigers take the lead. Off the faceoff, Needham, a drive, deflected in traffic. Pioneers try to clear. Needham keeps it in, runs it into the corner. 2:37 left in the period. In the far corner, the Pioneers dig it out, try to clear, bring it to the point, and they get out, and they've hit Laxinen, working one-on-one with Scott Swanson. He tries to center, and it's taken away by Brian Swanson. And he comes back near side to Scott, still in the Tiger end. And then Scott hits Laxinen with it. And the Pioneers keep it in the zone, but we've got a hand pass as Laxinen and Swanson stand face mask to face mask for a moment. And the officials step in to break things up. Have some rather hefty celebrities in the audience tonight from the WCHA. The supervisor of officials, Greg Shepherd, is here. He has seen each of the Tigers series for the last three weekends. He was in St. Cloud, he was in Madison, picking up one game here and there and then moving on to another site. But also in the house tonight is Bruce McLeod, the commissioner of the WCHA, who will be weighing the presentation of DUNCC for the WCHA's Final Five to move to the Rocky Mountains for a year in 1999. It'll be in St. Paul this year, and in 1998 it's scheduled for the Bradley Center in Milwaukee, but it could make its first trip out of the Midwest in 1999. The Tigers and DU could host it. Tigers push the puck into the Denver zone. It comes through the corner, far side. Comrie tries to get it out, connects with Murphy. Quickly, the Tigers get back to prevent an odd man. Run into the Tiger zone, pushed out by CC. Lead pass to Toby Peterson from Bodker, and then the Tigers run it into the Denver zone and change on the fly. Pioneers bring it back to neutral ice, coming in right point. Anders Bjork, Scott Swanson has lost his stick. He's picked up by Rude. Bjork is, and Rude swats it to neutral ice. Ian Peterson picks it up and swats it into the Denver zone. In pursuit is Hartnell and Austin. Puck is sent out of the zone, though, and comes back to Scott Swanson, who has retrieved his stick. Minute 27 left, and then Murphy takes it away from Swanson. Near corner to Buzan. Pioneers are in a change, so Buzan will have to create on his own. It drifts off his stick to the far side. Then to the point, Gunther launches. Covered up by Cugnet. Two Pioneers breaking from the far side. Both Gavin Morgan and Garrett Buzan, and Cugnet does not create a rebound. So play comes to a stop for another faceoff in the Tiger zone. 1:16 left in the period. And the Tigers on top, 3-2. Now, if this holds, if the Tigers are able to win tonight, they'll have a total of 34 points. They'll be tied with Minnesota for second and 3 points out of first after North Dakota lost tonight. But more importantly, the Tigers will have a 6-point bulge on Denver and will win the season series. However, there's always a however in this race. Duluth will leapfrog over the Pioneers and stay 4 points behind the Tigers. Drive from the left point is over the crossbar to the near side. Carpen has the rebound, runs it towards the Denver zone. It connects with Kerlick, and Elfring has to send it in finally. And then Darren breaks it up, and it comes right back into the Tiger zone. A minute two left in the period. Tigers have it poked away, grabbed by Hartnell. Hartnell's breaking out of the zone. Got Carpen on the right wing, can't deliver a pass. Pioneers take it off his stick high in the zone. Final minute of the period now. Tigers with the 3-2 lead. Pioneers bring it in to the neutral zone, now pushing into the Tiger zone, but Darren Clark is waiting for it. Cross ice, far side, to Dan Peters. Runs it off the boards. It hits Gavin Morgan. Clark pushes it ahead, looking for Brian Swanson, and it's taken away by Corbett in front of the penalty box. To Hacker and back to Corbett. And the Pioneer defenseman sends it far side to Buzan. He can't pick it off. Grabbed by Elfrink. Calvin pulls up behind the net, goes right wing to Scott Swanson. Final 21 seconds. Sent back in by Travis Smith. Tigers send it right back to the point, but Darren Clark has it come off his chest to Anderson. Elfrink takes it away, sends it behind the net. 12 seconds left. Pioneers have something working. Puts on the doorstep. Swept to the far side by Brian Swanson. Tigers dodge a bullet, clear it out with 4 seconds left in the period. Pioneers should have made this a tie game after two periods, but the Tigers live with the lead, at least through intermission. Second period over. Tigers lead 3-2. We'll be back after this timeout.
The technology in an Auric air machine can remove volcanic dust, purify the air in an atomic submarine, and believe it or not, even get rid of the odor from your teenager's sneakers. Hi, I'm David Auric. My Auric air machines catch up to 95% of all airborne particles, trapping particles as small as 1 micron. My tabletop model actually cleans the air in rooms up to 15 by 20 feet every 19 minutes. My multi-room console totally regenerates 18,000 cubic feet of air every hour. So things that drive your allergies crazy, like pollen, pet odors, cigarette smoke, can be a thing of the past. As with all my Auric products, you can take the Auric Challenge and try it free for 15 days, or ask for a free Auric air machine brochure. Call 1-800-989-4200. That's 1-800-989-4200. Of course, if your teenager sneakers smell like my grandson Greg's, you may need one for each foot.
Showtime presents the television event of the season.
Our country is running out of time.
Some only dream of changing the world. Others actually do.
I have fought against white domination. It is an ideal for which I am prepared to die.
Sidney Poitier, Michael Caine, Mandela and de Klerk. A powerful Showtime original picture. Premiering Sunday, February 16th at 8, Eastern and Pacific. Part of Showtime's salute to Black History Month.
We don't think much about heart disease until it touches our lives. But this Valentine's Day, New England Financial Services is asking you not only to think about heart disease, but also to give from the heart. On February 14th, representatives from the New England will be visiting local businesses selling Valentine's Day hearts. Your donation will benefit the American Heart Association and could also win you round-trip airfare on United Airlines to anywhere in the continental U.S. If your business would like to participate, call New England Financial Services at 632-8864. Your Southern Colorado representative of the New England.
Back live at the Cadet Ice Arena, the Tigers have posted a 3-2 lead after two periods of play. They led 2-0 after, or 2-1 after one, but the Pioneers came back with a goal in the second period to start the scoring. It was scored by Joe Murphy, and a beautiful goal it was for him as Antti Laaksonen walked out of the near side corner, circled the net, tried to wrap around. Cugnet kicked it out, but he kicked it right into the slot where Murphy was waiting, banged home the rebound, and the Pioneers got even at two apiece. But the Tigers' Toby Peterson came back 7 minutes and 38 seconds later, freed up the puck at neutral ice, an unassisted effort, and he just raced away from his teammates, and the Pioneer defense got in on Mullen, pulled him out of the net, and beat him to the stick side. Inside the left post and the right knee pad, and the Tigers took the lead back at 3-2. And that's what's going to have to happen here down the stretch. The Tigers are just going to have answers when their opponents score, much like Denver had an answer when the Tigers got off to the 2-0 lead. Saves in the second period. Jason Cugnet stopped 10 of the 11 shots he looked at. The Pioneers have 15 shots on net for the game. Jason has stopped 13. While at the other end, Jim Mullen stopped 7 shots. The Tigers only got 8 off this period, as Denver established itself territorially more so in the second period than it did in the first. Mullen has stopped 18-21. The Tigers have outshot the Pioneers 21-15. Penalties in the period, the Tigers took one. They now have 3 penalties for 6 minutes on the night. The Pioneers also took only 1 penalty, a lot less than the 5 they took in the first period, where they got themselves in trouble with the Tigers banging home 2 power play goals. Pioneers now have 6 penalties for 12 minutes, and that continues to be the story of why the Tigers are in control at the moment of this game. We take a timeout. Our Tiger profile will introduce you to a young man who isn't seeing a lot of ice time, but a player for the future. That's coming up after we pause for this timeout.
Hi, Kevin Wall here with an invitation to join me weekdays at high noon for Wall-to-Wall Sports.
Oh, I've been waiting a long time to hear you say that.
We talk to the biggest names in sports. We'll give you plenty of open phone time, plus anything goes on sports graffiti in a sentence or less.
Did you have to tell everybody?
So join us weekdays, noon till 4, for Wall-to-Wall Sports only on Sports Radio 1240 KRDO.
You know, it could be the solution to all of our problems.
You finally made the decision you're going to buy it. Yet as you look, the frustration grows and grows. You visit stores that have the product you want, but there's no one to talk to. And when you finally find a clerk, it's not their department, and they haven't got a clue. When was the last time you shopped in a store that specialized in what you were looking for? Here's Alicia from Shoemakers.
Helping you is what we specialize in. For over 65 years, Shoemakers Camera Shops has been helping, yes, helping people like you make good decisions about the photographic equipment that's right for you. When you shop Shoemakers, you'll find that everyone on our staff is passionate about photography. The value of quality service is immediately apparent. We take the time to find out what your needs are, then match you with the equipment that will deliver the best pictures you've ever taken. I'd like to personally invite you to our stores to experience the true value of real customer service.
Shoemakers Camera Shops, downtown at Kiowa and Tejon, and on the west side at 19th and Uinta next to the 7-Eleven.
Before you remodel your kitchen or bathroom, visit the Elger Inside Outhouse at Rampart Plumbing and Heating Supply. From sinks to tubs and faucets, Elger makes it easy to find what you're looking for. Rampart Plumbing and Heating Supply at 110 West Bermahoe, across from Chrissy Fowler Lumber. Rampart Plumbing and Heating Supply, a locally owned company since 1968.
Come on into the Inside Outhouse, Rampart Plumbing and Heating Supply.
Back live at the Cadet Ice Arena on the campus of the United States Air Force Academy. Tigers with a 3-2 lead after two periods of play. Our second period Tiger profile is a conversation with freshman defenseman slash forward Burke Nelson of Los Angeles, California, a man who was a sight for sore eyes. Now you're saying, how can you say that? Because he doesn't play very much. Well, he's really part of something the Tigers haven't had much over the course of the last 5 to 10 years, and that is depth, something CC has rarely had until lately. And for Burke, it's just plain good to be here.
You know, my first option is to make the hockey team and get as much playing time as I possibly do and try and help the team out. And right now, I think I've learned a lot. My skills improved a bit. I still have a long way to go, but it's been a great experience thus far.
And I know as you improve, so does the rest of the team. So getting that shot to play and to play with any kind of regularity is still something you have to keep reaching for every
right.
day.
It's very difficult to crack the line with the talent that this team possesses. You know, this is the best team I've ever played on in my life. The skill is, you know, it's impeccable, and the speed. It's an adjustment that I have to make if I want to, you know, contribute and help the team out. This league is great, and I think that I can, you know, definitely play in the league. There's just a lot of things I need to learn and a lot of things I need to work on to make myself a better player.
Sounds like you have a very high patience and tolerance level.
Yeah, I have to. You know, coming from California, I didn't get a lot of ice time, you know, skating maybe once or twice a week. And so you have to be patient, you know. If you continue to work hard, good things will come to you. You know, that's the motto that I live by, and that's the one that I'm going to keep living by. And hopefully, you know, things are going to work out as long as I keep working hard.
When it's not automatic, and by that I mean there were injuries last week that allowed you to get suited up and to be on the bench, yet there wasn't a regular shift. There wasn't the opportunity, so to speak, to really get out and either improve on what you have or demonstrate what you have. That's a different situation than just coming to practice every day. How are you dealing with that?
Well, the week before we played Duluth, I had been practicing on defense and hadn't been in the regular forward shifts. And so I think coach was a little skeptical of putting me out at forward, having not practiced at it all week. And he understands this, and I understand what he's thinking, so I try not to get frustrated by that because I know that he has confidence in my ability and my skill. So when he feels that I can contribute to the team in a positive way, then that's when he'll play me on a regular basis.
Well, I know to the fans of this program who have tolerated for decades tough years, you're a precious commodity because you typify a word that hasn't been in the vocabulary here, and that's depth. And now you're fighting to get that chance to play. Have you ever felt like the coaches or the rest of the team have left you behind or not given you what it takes to one day be a part on an active basis on the ice?
I don't feel that way at all. This team has taken me in, and you know, I feel just like one of the players. You know, I don't have any problems with anybody on the team. This is probably the team I've felt closest to throughout, you know, my hockey experience, which is an odd thing because prior to coming to CC, you know, I was a key player. I logged a lot of ice time and had, you know, an outcome on some of the games that were played. But, you know, here it's different. You know, I'm more of a role player and trying to find out where I can fit in on this team. And the fact that they haven't, you know, shunned me away from, you know, team activities or left me out of things makes me feel that much more comfortable at CC.
That's Burke Nelson, our Tiger profile for the second intermission, and very patiently waiting his turn. And usually good things come to those who wait, to borrow an old cliche, if you will. His time has just not come, but when it will, he will be ready to step in. And in times like this, when the Tigers have had a growing injury list and where players are on and off the active roster, Burke has taken his step in. He played some at Wisconsin last week and, of course, is going to have his time. And right now, he's having his impact every day at practice, and that, of course, helps to make this team a lot better. Well, we're going to take a timeout when we come back. Third period is around the corner, and when Denver University trails after two periods of play, they've won only once this year in eight games, 1-7 after trailing in two periods of play. So the Tigers with a 3-2 lead are looking to build on that, get the victory, close within three of North Dakota, and catch Minnesota for second place. Can they do that? That's the question that will be answered when we come back.
It's like the saying goes, there's always free cheese in a mousetrap. Hi, Dave Workman, president of Soundtrack. You'll hear a lot of stores boast, we have the lowest prices around. It's almost like cheese in a mousetrap. In reality, all consumer electronics dealers price shop each other's stores to stay competitive. And that's why the same product will be about the same price no matter where you go. At Soundtrack, price is only the beginning, not the end. We still believe in this thing called value. In fact, we built a 28-year reputation around it. It's things like an uncompromising attitude towards customer service, offering more choices in every category we sell, extensively training our sales specialists, or backing your purchase with an ultimate 60-day price guarantee. Now that's value. So if it's a complete electronics experience you want and a low price, then come to the electronics specialist. Come to Soundtrack.
And look for our big 8-page insert in Saturday's Rocky Mountain News, Denver Post, and other Front Range newspapers. Soundtrack. Big names, little prices, guaranteed.
You live for sports. 24 hours a day, you eat, drink, and sleep sports. But you can't follow every game all the time. Until now. ESPN and the area's leading pager provider, AirTouch Paging, have teamed up to provide a service made for sports hounds like you. ESPN Net2Go. With your alphanumeric pager from AirTouch Paging, you'll now be able to get the latest scores for all major pro and collegiate team sports. Along with score updates, ESPN Net2Go brings you game information and details, plus exclusive ESPN features like sports headline news. With AirTouch Paging and ESPN Net2Go, you'll be the first to know what's happening in the world of sports, no matter where you are or what you're doing. Score updates every 5 minutes, top 25 college rankings, game schedules with point spread, and much, much more. It's as close as your alphanumeric pager from AirTouch Paging and ESPN Net2Go. Visit AirTouch Paging at Carefree and Academy behind Bennigan's and check out the latest way to use your pager with ESPN Net2Go. Call 573-6500.
We are back at the Cadet Ice Arena. We're just about set to go with a faceoff for period number three, a very telling period, not just for tonight, but for the season. Tigers with a 3-2 lead. Minnesota has lost. North Dakota has lost. The Tigers have everything right in their hands if they're ready to go for it. In the National Hockey League tonight, Washington has defeated Tampa Bay 5-4, and Detroit has a 3-2 lead over Dallas in the third period of play. We have a little bit of time left before we start the third period, so we'll take a quick look at the highlights if we have them ready in the truck from period number two, where the Pioneers got one back. And again, this is the great work Antti Laaksonen, and this is where he is so good. Look how strong, fighting through Toby Peterson, gets it off Cugnet, and then the rebound is there for Murphy, who bangs it home. But Toby Peterson will atone for that. Watch him break out here as he breaks up the play, heads to the net, beats Jim Mullen cleanly, and the Tigers take the lead back at 3-2. And now we're to live action as the Tigers bring the puck into the Denver zone. In the near corner, Kreiway tries to set up Darren Clark. The two collide. Puck comes along the near side point. Needham sends it back through the corner. Pioneers pick it up there. Send it behind the net to Travis Smith. Try to break out. Put it on the right wing boards. Tigers are crashing. Keep it in the zone, and Antti Laaksonen has to go in front of his own net. Circles the far circle. Gets around Darren Clark. Dishes to Eric Anderson, swept off his stick by the Tiger defense and sent to neutral ice. It rolls off the near boards to Mullen. Mullen's going to put his team in transition as the Tigers short shift. Needham breaks it up, but it's picked up at the point by the Pioneers, kept in. Anderson tries to send it down low. Needham wraps it up, got a whistle, and a hand pass. So play will stop for a faceoff with 19:14 left in the period. And the faceoff will take place in the Tiger zone above the near circle, right at the left point. And the assistant referee, Tim Switer, waits to put Toby Peterson and Anders Bjork together. Toby, the freshman from Bloomington, Minnesota. And, of course, you know his story. He would have been a high school senior this year. Finished up all his academics last summer. Turned 18 in the fall. Tigers have the puck. Bodgren at the right point tries to put it between the legs of Ritson, and Ritson, the freshman defenseman, breaks up the play and halts Bodker in his tracks. Tigers field it at neutral ice after the Pioneers clear, sends it back in. Mullen sends it up the near side. Tigers turn it over, or intercept the turnover, rather, and Toby Peterson misfires. Here's a drive from the left point by Scott Swanson, saved by Mullen. Tigers buzzing here in the early stages of period number three. Pioneers finally get it out. It goes deep into the Tiger end. Cugnet's going to play it up the far side. Connects with Dan Peters, shovels it near side to Toby Peterson. Toby's coming back one-on-one with Petri Gunther, rolls it slowly into the near corner. Tigers will make a change. Travis Smith out of the corner to Gavin Morgan, right wing to Petri Gunther, full head of steam, splits the defense, and then has it swatted away by Darren Clark. Keeps it in at the point. Clark, or rather Hartnell. Hartnell keeps it. Comes in at the right point. He may launch. Gets around one man. Loses his stick and goes down. He had a break to the net, but didn't have his stick. Puck comes free. Tandberg digs it out in the corner. Backhands it behind the net. Picked off by Petri Gunther. And the Swedish defenseman sets up Travis Smith. His long lead pass deflected by Elfring. Cugnet plays it. Steers it behind the net. This is where Cugnet is. Is so good. Oh, the Pioneers dig it out along the near boards, put it behind the net. Tigers Bob Needham takes it away. Cugnet can play the puck after he's seen the shot or seen the play developing, and that is not Judd Lambert's strength. Lambert, on the other hand, has ice water in his veins and is a little more collected. Puck in the corner, brought to the near side by the Pioneers in their own zone. Ritson looks up ice, decides to stick handle out. He's one of those freshmen that might make the all-rookie team. Brings it in at the left point, has it swatted away. Tigers break it up, and out of the zone comes K.J. Voorhees. One-on-one with Kurlik. Tries to get inside. They sandwich him, take the puck away. Picked up by Ritson, sent near side. Warren Smith brings it in. Looks to center. Rude rides him to the corner. Smith wheels out of the corner and tries to center. Rude breaks that up. Puck free along the near boards in the corner. You get a good look at it from our end zone camera. Up to the point, Charlie Host trying to keep it in. Dishes to Smith, tries to get around Rude. Rude wraps him up. Smith fights through it, gets towards the net. Now help comes from Carpen. Puck along the near boards as Smith is driven back. Centers, man open, wrist shot. Cugnet comes out, makes the save, rebound. Oh, the Pioneers miss an open net. Tigers catch a real break. Pioneers still have it. Behind the net, Comrie centers right to Aaron Carpen. Oh, Carpen doesn't clear, nearly scores on his own goaltender. Tigers push it to neutral ice. They need a shift change, and it happens. In comes Travis Smith into the corner, picked up by Bob Needham. Boy, that was certainly almost a call for the emergency services, the way the Tigers handle that into that shift. Out of the zone comes CC. Cryway to Brian Swanson. Swanson wrapped up by Anderson. Picked up by Clark. Connects with Brian Swanson. Swanson loses control, and it's sent in deep by Anderson. Comes right out of the corner behind the net. Cugnet is out of the net, and they try to flip it over the crossbar to a crashing James Patterson, but the puck eludes him. Picked up by Brian Swanson. Moves in, goes to the net as it poked off his stick. Clark retrieves. Clark looks inside. Tries to center. Ricochets off Petri or Anderson to the corner. Tigers try to dig it out. Pioneers are right there with them. Squirts free along the near boards. Grabbed by Loxton and pushed to the point and neutralized. Elfring tries to keep it alive, but Patterson knocks it away. Picked up by Darren Clark, sent back in. Right to Kerlick, though, and then Kerlick sends it back out. Elfring drives it back in. Kerlick fields it near side. 15:30 left in the period. Pioneers send Anders Bjork to the Tiger blue line. He's wrapped up by Danny Peters. Pioneers make a change. Elfring picks up the puck near side to Peters. Off the near boards for Bodker. It connects. Bodker shovels it left wing to Ian Peterson. Full head of steam. Gets inside. Shoots, and it's knocked down by Jim Mullen. And Ian Peterson goes into the boards. Forechecking Tigers try to free it up. Keep it in at the blue line. Peters tries to fire, and oh, a late call by Chris Shook says the Tigers are offside. And we got a whistle again after the play, and will we have a penalty here? Mike Schmidt sizing up the situation. No, he will not make a call. We'll pause for a timeout and return. 15:09 left in the period. Tigers still with a 3-2 lead.
Put some magic in your life. Home lighting, where quality shines.
Discover a beautiful new way to light a room at Home Lighting, serving Colorado Springs for more than 44 years. Shop their wonderful selection of lamps and ceiling fans, and look to Home Lighting for lampshades and complete repair service too. Home Lighting, downtown at 624 North Tejon.
Home Lighting, where quality shines through.
Welcome back. 15:09 left in regulation. Tigers clinging to a 3-2 lead. Full house, standing room only again tonight at the Cadet Ice Arena as the Tigers look to go back into second place with a win tonight, as Minnesota was defeated by Duluth. And of course the Gophers come in here next week. Pioneers try to clear the puck, but a delay, illegal use of the stick call whistled by the referee Mike Schmidt. Tigers, when they ran it in deep, had one of the Pioneers, I believe it was Petri Gunther, get his stick up in the air and deflect the puck, and then the Pioneers picked it up again, and that is truly illegal use of the stick. The other team must touch up before you can attack the puck. Faceoff will come above the near circle in the Denver zone. Toby Peterson, who right now has the game leading goal, wins the draw, comes to Needham. Needham shovels it to Scott Swanson, takes a drive, comes off the end boards, right to Toby Peterson, backhands it down low, broken up by Bjork. Comes to the near corner. Ian Peterson tries to dig it out. Hemmed into the boards by a pair of red shirts. And Toby Peterson watches it squirt free, picks it up. Has it poked off his stick, holds his balance, centers while going down. Pioneers intercept. Tigers keep it at the blue line. Needham sends it off the boards. Back behind the net looking for Peterson. Mullen steps in front of Toby, sends it up the near side. Kept in again by Needham. To Ian Peterson. Back to Toby in the corner. Pretty good buzz here by the Tigers. Peters steps around. Ritson centers. Man open. Rashad. Oh, Bodker nearly had the fourth goal of the night. Knockdown blocker saved by Jim Mullen. Kerlick picks it up, clears it out, and the Pioneers ice the puck just to get the Tigers off their back and get a line change. Not a good shift for that line of the Pioneers, and George Gwozdecki is all over his Pioneers when he come off the ice. 14:13 left in the period. We'll pause for another timeout. Faceoff in the Denver zone when we come back after this.
When selling property, look to Lovett and Associates for results. Lovett and Associates provide an excellent source of buyers moving into the Springs area and will get the highest dollar possible for your home. Lovett and Associates has a proven track record in home sales and are members of one of the largest relocation services. Let the highly trained staff at Lovett and Associates assist you in the sale of your home. For unparalleled service and home sale results, call Lovett and Associates at 392-9031. Now celebrating their 30th year.
We're back. Tigers keeping the pressure up after the faceoff. Puck has stayed in the DU zone. Eric Rude backs it into the near corner. Pushed up by Ryan Hacker. Intercepted by Paul Johnson. Sends it back to the point to Rude. Turns it on net. Mullen makes the save. Rebound John Austin. Looks to snipe for the goal. And Mullen hangs on. Paul Johnson in his face. And oh, Johnson is run into from behind. Mike Schmidt saw it all. Johnson pushed by Mullen as he was standing his ground out front. And let's see if... This turns out to be coincidentals. And Mike Schmidt is in the face of Jim Mullen, the goaltender. Johnson had stopped in the slot. Let's take a look at this again if we can, because this is a critical point in the game. Tigers with a 3-2 lead. Johnson is going to get a penalty, but let's see if the Pioneers wind up with a couple. All right, you see Johnson down low. He stops. Two players are pushing on him. And then Mullen gets in his face. There's a shove from one Pioneer, and then a hit from behind by another, and Paul Johnson has done nothing further but talk back. Let's see if we see a couple of red shirts go in there. I've only seen one so far. Paul Johnson is one in the box. And Kerlick is in the box for Denver. Mike Schmidt is not going to make two calls here on the Pioneers, although he easily could have. It is not Kerlick. It is John Newman that's in the box for Denver. The penalties come with 13:45 left in the third period, 6 minutes and 15 seconds in. And the way they're posted on the board, there'll be 2 minute minors and nobody else is headed to the box. We'll play 4-on-4. Brian Swanson looks to win the draw and winds up on the ice. And Chris Shook says that's an encroachment by Eric Anderson. So Antti Laaksonen will step up to work against the sophomore from Eagle River, Alaska. Puck comes near corner. Travis Smith fields it. 4-on-4 is to the Tigers' liking. Out of the zone comes Antti Laaksonen. Oh, Brian Swanson picks his pocket, tries to push it ahead. Travis Smith takes it, though. Brings it in at the right point. Tries to get around Scott Swanson. Swanson delivers the check. Pioneers have 2 men along the far side boards. Darren Clark steps in, but puts it on the stick of Laaksonen. Hard check by Needham. And then Scott Swanson overskates the puck, giving Anderson an alley. Needham takes it back to Brian Swanson at neutral ice. Drop passes the point for Needham. Whistle, Tigers offside. Or are we going to get a penalty here? Tigers are ruled offside. There will not be a penalty. And the faceoff will come above the Denver blue line with 13:15 left in regulation and 1:30 left on the coincidentals to Newman and to Paul Johnson. Well, Mike Schmidt, who we thought might tag the Pioneers with 2 penalties there, in full view. He saw everything we saw. The cameras were right on top of it. He was right on top of it. And he elected to call coincidentals. Faceoff will come again just across the Denver blue line with 13:15 remaining in what has been a very entertaining game here tonight at the Cadet Ice Arena. Always is when these two teams get together. Faceoff is won by the Tigers. Dan Peters runs it through the end zone. 4-on-4 for another 1:25. Ritson behind the Denver net. Waits for his Pioneers to balance off to Anders Bjork on the left wing. Going to stick handle high through the Denver zone. And all the way into the Tigers zone at the right point. Runs it into the corner. Collides with Chris Shook. Tigers pick up the puck behind the net as Cugnet slows it. Dug out by Elfrink. Tries to push it ahead to Hartnell. He's wrapped up by Bjork. Comrie has it, sends it through the slot. Nobody's there. Tigers are playing man for man with Pioneers breaking through the slot and didn't allow any connection. Pioneers send it through the end zone. Oh, and then as Ritson tries to take a shot, Hartnell blocks it, picks it up, comes in, takes the drive, scores! Chad Hartnell, 5 holes! Jim Mullen! Hartnell beating Jim Mullen after picking the pocket of Warren Smith up top, and the Tigers push the lead to 2 goals at 4-2. We'll take a look at this one, and Hartnell just made a terrific play in the defensive end. As you can see, he pushed it out of the zone, headed back the other way. Mullen was ready, but Hartnell got it through the 5-hole. Mullen didn't quite close the gap enough, and the senior assistant captain from Lloydminster, British Columbia, has the first goal of the third period. 12:32 in, 7:28 into the period, 12:32 remaining, and Hartnell picks up goal number 6 of the season and 22 for his career. And let's see if they call that unassisted, and they probably should because he broke up the play. It is unassisted, broken up in the Denver zone. So the Tigers have 2 unassisted goals here tonight. Toby Peterson and Chad Hartnell. Back to action. Puck near boards. Bodker has it. Breaks to the net. Gets inside. He's run off the puck and then he collides with Mullen in the goalpost and looks to see if he's going to get a call from Mike Schmidt on the play by Mike Darren. But Darren, in all honesty, used the angle in the body properly and broke up the play. They'll reset the pipes. So we'll pause for a timeout and come back. Tigers now with a 2-goal lead at 4-2.
It's the number one cause of household electrical fires. Improperly used extension cords. Don't gamble with your family's safety. Instead, consider these electrical safety tips from Whitney Electric. Check extension cords often for worn and frayed areas. If cords are worn to the touch, discontinue their use immediately. But the best electrical safety precaution is to add another receptacle in the area where the extension cord is being used. For a safe bet, call 473-4212 and connect with the winning team at Whitney Electric.
We are back at the Cadet Ice Arena with 12:01 remaining in the third period. Tigers now with a 4-2 lead. Faceoff far circle, John Austin working against Garrett Bruzon. Or actually Warren Smith. Smith wins the draw. Travis Smith behind the Denver net. Scoots it up the right side to Kerlick. Kerlick, the assistant captain, looks for Charlie Host, just misfires. Cugnet plays it alongside the net. Dug out by Elfring behind the net. 11:45 to go. Pioneers Smith has it near side, centers it. John Austin is waiting for it. Heads it back the other way to Paul Johnson. Johnson tries to ride it in. It's poked off his stick, grabbed by Hartnell, and then taken by Kerlick, who sends it in. And then Cugnet covers up, and coming into Cugnet is John Newman. And we got tempers breaking out in the far corner as John Austin is having words with one of the Pioneers. Dan Peters coming in also to assist his friend John Austin. A couple of other pairing off by players from both teams, although no blows are exchanged other than verbal, and the officials just sort of watch to make sure nothing develops from it. Now you'll take a look at it. Cugnet makes the stop, shovels it, wants to shovel it behind the net, and then in comes Newman. But in all honesty, that videotape shows him bouncing off of Chad Hartnell and ricocheting into Cugnet. So there is no need to make any penalty call unless extracurricular breaks out on top of that. Cugnet and Mullen have gone all the way for their respective teams. And right now the Tigers are having the better of it at 4-2. Near side corner, Darren Clark nearly turns it over. Cam Cryway tries to clear. Hacker keeps it in. Scott Swanson takes his centering pass, dishes to Brian. Long lead pass, nearly found Cryway for a breakaway. Broken up by Travis Smith. Tigers try to pick it up and neutralize. Pioneers start playing the body and come in. Here's Loxton and shoots. Cugnet the save, can't find it. Now falls over on top of it. And play is stopped, and that was a dangerous play. An accident launched from above the left circle. Cugnet made the stop, but wasn't too terribly sure of his effort. And of course, coming in on the right wing, looking for the rebound, was the captain, Eric Anderson. And we'll see the replay again on it here as the Tigers try to hold off the Swede and the Finn. Cugnet not too sure of it, looking for it. It's actually in his glove. And you can see Anderson there on the doorstep waiting for a rebound that was not to be. Now 11:02 left in regulation. Tigers up 4-2 to the point to Ritson. Ritson runs it through the corner. Far side, Murphy after it. Rude gets there first, backhands it to the point. It rides the rail, but the Pioneers keep it in. Send it down low. Behind the net, dug out by Dan Peters. Peters off the near side boards, can't deliver out of the zone. Toby Peterson picks it up. Comes behind the net, scoots it off the near boards to neutralize. Picked up by Kerlick. Bodker breaks it up. Kerlick still manages to get it into the Tiger zone. Rude fields it, sends it off the glass. It finds Ritson high in the Denver zone. Sends it back to neutralize. Tigers play the body, free it up. But it's fielded by Ritson. Oh, Stu Bodker collides with Ritson, takes him down. Puck comes free in the Tiger zone. Ian Peterson to Toby Peterson. Tries to step around one man, is wrapped up, shoved to the ice. No call, Voorhees after it. Actually, Gavin Morgan made a pretty good play on that. Pioneers bring it out in front of the Tiger bench, carried into the Tiger zone. It goes to the far corner. Who's on behind the net. Eric Rude's all over him. Wraps him up. Loses his stick to who's on. Now Toby Peterson helps out. Stick handles away from the net, but loses the puck. Kept in at the point by Gunther. Looks down low. Tigers' Bob Needham breaks it up. Now Needham is down and on top of the puck with two Pioneers all over him. 9:46 to play, and Needham comes up in a shoving match with the Pioneers, Gavin Morgan. And the officials have to step in. And of course, you've got the best view in the house, in your own house. with our end zone camera right there to see it all. And Needham being held to the boards there by Tim Swider. Bob is playing with some sort of an injury or perhaps an equipment problem. Well, if he's hurt, it hasn't seemed to really affect him, but he left in the first period with Richard Quince into the dressing room, and usually Quince doesn't go unless there's some medical need, because Tommy Thurston is more than capable of handling any equipment problem. But Needham did come back out for the second period and has not missed a shift since. Faceoff will come at the Colorado College zone, near circle, and looking to win the draw. The Tigers' John Austin gets the job done. To Cal Elfring, to Paul Johnson. He's wrapped up in the corner. Now pops it open again to Elfring. Elfring has his pocket pick. Pioneers have it. Center man open. Quick wrist shot is just wide. Cugnet got a piece of it. It's loose behind the Tiger net. 9:29 to go. Tigers with a two-goal lead at 4-2. Up the far side, it hits the referee, and it's kept in at the point. Sent down low, it drifts to the near corner. Tigers go after it along with the Pioneers, and it's sent up the near side, and the Tigers have Chad Hartnell out of the zone. Coming in one-on-one with Kurlick, looks towards the net, centers, that's just behind John Austin, drifts to the far side. Warren Smith will pick it up, back the other way, he's looking right in the eyes of Dan Peters. Peters pokes the puck away to the near side. Tigers will gather it in. Pioneers are finishing a line change, and Hartnell will run it slowly into the near corner so CC can change the checkers. In the near corner, Denver zone. Brian Swanson tries to free it up, it's taken by Petri Gunther, sends it to the near side, over Laaksonen, fired from the point by Rude, deflected by Brian Swanson, saved by Mullen, sent through the end zone to the far side, Tigers forecheck to keep it in, Darren Clark overskates it, Pioneers get out, Antti Laaksonen, one-on-one with Scott Swanson, Swanson flicks the puck away and delivers the body, Rude sweeps it up the far side, Tigers poke it to the point, waiting for it is Gunther. Tries to send it down low. Man open. Drive. Knocked down by a diving Tiger defenseman, Scott Swanson. Anderson picks it up. Got a man open. Near side. One-timer. Cugnet the save. He saw the whole play. Made the big stop. Anderson saw Ritson. Cugnet saw Anderson saw Ritson. And Cugnet got in Ritson's face in time to make the point-blank range save. 8:20 to go. The two teams will change up. We'll take another timeout. Tigers lead it 4-2.
Cub Foods and Coca-Cola are proud to sponsor CC Tiger Hockey and can help you save on your overall food bill with everyday savings. Because Cub Foods buys in quantities big enough to demand huge discounts from suppliers, you'll save on more than 25,000 name brand products store-wide, like Coca-Cola products. Pick up 12 packs of your thirst-quenching favorites for just $2.68. Visit any Colorado Springs Cub Foods today and join the savings celebration. Cub Foods, lower prices every aisle, every shelf, every day. Cub Foods, the spendless store.
Okay, we're back, and a faceoff imminent in the Denver zone. Toby Peterson to work against the Pioneers, Anders Bjork from Stockholm, Sweden. Toby from Bloomington, Minnesota. Bjork wins the draw, but he's bird-dogged by the Tigers. Stu Bodker, who clears it out of the zone. Oh, Toby Peterson wrapped up, pulled down. There's not going to be a call. That allows Ryan Hacker to get the puck, sends it up the far side, backhanded through the Tiger zone. Cugnet swirls it behind the net to the near side. Danny Peters pushes it to neutral ice and beyond. Ian Peterson in a race. The icing call is waved off. 7:56 remains. Forechecking Tigers try to keep it in. Oh, and now we've got a penalty coming behind the net, I believe. No, we don't. Pioneers in transition. Drop pass, man open, drive, Cugnet to save, rebound loose, another drive, deflected, blocker stop, short side by Cugnet. Puck comes to the near corner. Good flurry by the Pioneers, but Cugnet comes up strong. Toby Peterson rolls it into the Denver zone. CC makes a change. Fielded far side by Laaksonen. Near side to Gunther. One-on-one against Root. Comes in, centers it, goes to the slot unmolested. Darren Clark fields it off the far boards. Heads back the other way. One-on-one with Kurlick. Splits the defense, gets inside, dives, and can't get the shot off. It hurdles over Mullen into the cage, and the crowd comes to its feet, roaring at the hustle of Darren Clark. They thought he might be able to catch that puck and fire it past Mullen, but he couldn't quite get there. Mullen broke up the play, and Clark, trying to avoid contact, hurtled over Mullen into the cage and sent the cage almost to the end boards. I'll see it again. Look at Clark. He is not giving up. He wants to beat Mullen here, gets the shot off, and then makes sure he doesn't make contact. And play is stopped with 7:16 left. Just been handed a note from DU Sports Information Director Dave Moline. In the last four games that DU and CC has played, DU has not scored a goal in the third period. And of course, he earlier informed us that the Pioneers, after trailing when the first two periods are completed, have not won but once in eight games. So their record 1-7 when they've been behind after two periods. Not a very good come from behind team. And with all this firepower, it's hard to understand. Up the ice comes Laxton. Poked off his stick, picked up by Anderson, whirls and fires on the net. Cognet to save, rebound comes off the end boards, and Jason has to cover up. Now 7 minutes separating the Tigers from second place in the WCHA where they were a week ago. Tigers trying to capitalize on losses to the top two teams in the league. Both North Dakota and Minnesota have fallen tonight. North Dakota lost to Northern Michigan on a very, very strange turn of events at Lakeview tonight in a 1-1 game. Northern Michigan in the dying seconds scored on an empty North Dakota net. Until we hear all the details, it's hard to fathom that Dean Blaze would pull his goaltender in a 1-1 tie. Now maybe they were able to get North Dakota's goaltender out of the net somehow and scored an empty netter. At the point, Petri Gunther to the right point, thinking one time, but then thinking again is Laxinen. Puck three in the far corner. Centering pass comes right to Stu Bodker. To Ian Peterson and then back to Bodker. Bodker leads the rush up the ice. Tigers are back 3-on-2. The Pioneers are slow to come back. Bodker dumps it in deep. With the two-goal lead, the Tigers are not going to take any chances to create an odd man for the Pioneers the other way. Denver digs it out near boards. The neutral ice comes right to Scott Swanson. Swanson backhands it in deep again, and the Tigers are offside. Both Toby Peterson and Stu Bodker were in from the previous rush. So play comes to a halt for the offside call, and the faceoff will come at neutral ice. At Mariucci, the hard thing to figure is how does Duluth score 8 goals on the Gophers in their own building, especially after trailing 3-1. That was a good old-fashioned whipping. And I'm sure Doug Woog, who has not been happy with his team's offensive production, they get off to a 3-1 lead. Below it, 5 unanswered goals stake the Bulldogs to a 6-3 lead, and they parlay that into an 8-4 win. Hard to figure, but this is the WCHA after all. Puck near boards, neutral ice, and a player on top of the puck, so play is stopped. Hartnell and Kerlick unfold. I think Hartnell may have had the puck in his uniform somewhere. And Chris Shook finally finds the disc and we'll go back to work here in the neutral zone. Warren Smith will face off against John Austin. And Mike Darren and Chad Hartnell continue to talk, and Darren gives him a shove, and Mike Schmidt tells Hartnell that's enough. And Darren gives Hartnell another shove. Pioneers come up with the puck. This is Kerlick. Sends it up the far side, and we got a whistle. That puck goes into the bench, and Brian Swanson says, I don't want it, you take it, and puts it in the crowd. So somebody winds up with a souvenir. 6:11 left, and another faceoff coming in the neutral zone. Same two teams tomorrow night. We will not be televising from Denver, but we will have the game on sports radio. AM 1240 KRDO at 6:45. And we'll see if the Tigers are moving closer to the top of the standings, holding on to second place, or having the B team show up tomorrow night. It's all in the Tigers' hands. Eric Rude picks it up, runs it into the near corner. Fielded by Joe Ritson, sends it up the near side, but the Pioneers had vacated, so Eric Rude sends it back in deep. Fielded far side by Warren Smith. Paul Johnson delivers a check. Tigers work to dig it out. Instead, it's picked up by Kerlick behind the net to Ritson, and Ritson will try again. And this time, the freshman defenseman puts it on the left wing for Charlie Host from St. Cloud, Minnesota. Host runs it into the far corner. Pioneers make a change. Brian Swanson picks it up. Heads back up ice, looking for Darren Clark. He's wrapped up by Ritson. The puck goes the length of the ice, and the Tigers are tagged for icing. We'll take a timeout and return. 5:22 left. Tigers still on top by a score of 4-2.
From the very tall to the very small, Colorado loves hockey. February 13th through the 17th, hockey's youngest and brightest stars hit the ice in the 20th annual President's Day Youth Hockey Tournament. It's one of the largest and most prestigious youth hockey tournaments in the country. Over 75 teams from the U.S. and Canada will face off during this four-day event. Come be a part of the excitement as we celebrate youth hockey at its finest. For more information, call 540-3600, extension 115. The 20th annual President's Day Youth Hockey Tournament is sponsored by Wendy's, Century Communications, and KRDO.
Tigers have the puck behind their own net, send it up the far side, kept in by the Pioneers. Now the Tigers yield in the corner. Denver wants to center. Tigers bottle up the red and gold. Pioneers take it back, bring it to the point. One-timer, Hacker deflected in traffic. Rebound comes off the boards to Stu Botker near side. Stu can't get it out. Kept in by Bjork. It runs through the corner. Needham picks it up, winds up, and clears it the length of the ice. And CC will take an icing call here just to get the Pioneers off their back. They are really buzzing right now. And as you know, we have had the scores published here. Duluth wins. So the Pioneers risk falling into seventh tonight. And nobody on that Pioneer bench wants to give up another 2 points, for they might be playing on the road in the playoffs. There's George Gwozdecki on the Denver bench, and he's really been after his team tonight. Not terribly characteristic of him, but his team has just not really fought back. Has had some moments of brilliance offensively, but the Tigers have outplayed him tonight. Now to the far side. Kerlick tries to send it in deep. Comes behind the net. Scott Swanson backhands it near side. Darren Clark digs it out. And now he's going to streak out of the zone. Got Brian Swanson ahead of the field. He just misses completing the pass. Laaksonen intercepts. Darren waited just a split second too long. He had Scott or Brian on the break. Now the Pioneers back the other way to Gavin Morgan at the left point. Drop pass Petri Gunther. Gunther's got an alley to the net. Drops it at the blue line. Kerlick shoots. Broken up by Bob Needham. It drifts to the near side off the stick of Scott Swanson. Pioneers send it behind the net. Petri Gunther far side. Hammered by Needham. Pushed towards the point by Kryway. Pioneers send it back to the corner. Frozen along the far boards. Squirts free. Now to the blue line. Pioneers keep it in. Send it through the corner near side behind the net. Gavin Morgan has it. Wants to center. Scott Swanson bottles up one body. Eric Anderson picks it up. Up top to Ryan Hacker. Going to let loose. Deflected over the crossbar. Dug out in the corner by Morgan. Morgan's been everywhere on this shift. He's taken hits from Needham and Swanson. And Morgan is still on the puck. Still in the corner. Working to free it up. Brian Swanson tips it away. Tries to clear it out. Pioneers keep it in. Wrist shot. Goal! The Pioneers get a wrist shot from their captain, Eric Anderson. The Tigers just could not get a clear, and Eric Anderson has the Pies back within a goal. It's not over with yet. 3:39 remaining. The Tigers now will be fighting for dear life. We'll take our last timeout. Come back for the final 3 minutes and 39 seconds. Stay with us. This is Tiger Hockey.
Wasn't Valentine's Day sweet? Maybe a little too sweet. So now what's on everyone's lips?
I thought this belt was longer.
Oh, these pants are great, as long as I don't move.
This skirt must have shrunk in the closet.
Sounds like a good time for Quaker Caramel Corn Cakes, the fat-free snack with the delicious taste of caramel popcorn. And each big, crunchy cake is just 50 calories, so there's no need for excuses. Fat-free Quaker Caramel Corn Cakes, 50 calories, zero excuses.
3:27 left as we come back. Tigers have the puck in the Denver zone through the corner. Paul Johnson trying to play it. Warren Smith gets there first, sends it out. Broken up by Hartnell and kept in. Chad's racing forward along the far boards. It's kept in at the point by Austin. Sends it to the slot, but it's intercepted by Ritson. Sends it up the near side. Ryan Hacker looking to try and get it out of the zone, and he does, but Dan Peters is waiting for it. Sends it off the glass through the end zone behind the Denver net. Toby Peterson after it in the corner. Hips. Ritz into the boards, takes it away, got a man open. Here's Ian Peterson. Oh, he just missed. Toby set up his brother beautifully, and he just missed. Getting a piece of it was Jim Mullen. That would have clinched it with 2:48 to go, but Ian Peterson could not finish off. Puck driven into the Tiger end, and one of the officials trying to separate three players along the far boards as Hacker tries to get off the ice. Play continues. Tigers had a man tied up there with Hacker. Pioneers clear it to the near side boards in their own end, then back into the corner. Travis Smith with 2.5 left, puts it on the right wing. Kerlak's going to get out of the zone, sends it ahead, connects with Murphy. Murphy's around, Needham into the corner, backhands it to the far boards, down to the point. Rashad cut it to save. Oh, and it's cleared out magnificently by Calvin Elfring. Oh, Calvin Elfring saved the Tigers a goal as Cugnet was out of position on the ricochet. Let's take a look at that one again. Watch the shot into the slot. Cugnet makes the save. Oh, that's the goal that was scored by Eric Anderson. I thought we were going to see the replay of the save that Elfring made. But Anderson's, well, actually, they're going to give that goal to Gavin Morgan, a deflection. Anderson gets the assist, as does Joe Ritson. So Gavin Morgan picks up the goal for the Pioneers, and that is his sixth of the year. Anderson with the assist. And for Anderson, it is his 11th of the year. And for Darren, or for Joe Ritson, it is his ninth assist of the year. The Pioneers have called for a timeout. Get a look at Don Lucia as he starts to talk strategy with the Tigers. There's 2 minutes and 15 seconds left, and the way this game has moved tonight, I think that George Gwozdecki was afraid if he waited for another faceoff, there may not be one until too late to set his strategy to get Jim Mullen out of the net. Puck will be dropped right in that circle on that dot in the near circle of the Colorado College zone when play resumes. Now you get a look at the University of Denver huddle with head coach George Gwozdecki as you listen to Tiger Hockey on Sports Radio, AM 1240, KRDO Radio, Colorado Springs, Colorado, and as you watch on cable channel 70 from KRDO TV 13 and Century Communications. Our next cable channel 70 telecast will be next Friday night at 7:30 when the Minnesota Gophers come to town. That will be followed by the Saturday afternoon game at 2 o'clock between the Gophers and the Tigers. Well, the Pioneers have set their strategy, but Jim Mullen is coming back out in front of the net. George Gwozdecki is not ready yet to pull the string on Mullen. Faceoff will come near circle, as we mentioned. Now we're going to see the play by Cal Elfring. Cugnet makes the save, loses sight of the puck, and Elfring sweeps it out. That's the play of the game defensively at the moment. Tigers, Brian Swanson wins the draw. Scott Swanson in the corner with it. Tigers need to put the puck into the Denver zone and apply some pressure. Forechecking Pioneers keep it alive in the CC zone, though. In the corner, Pioneers now pull Jim Mullen out of the net with 2:03 to go. They've got the advantage they want. On comes the extra attacker. Centering pass goes through the slot to the far side. Net is empty at the other end. Tigers now fighting off a 6-on-5. Puck in the corner. Tigers dig it out. Scott Swanson whirls, sends it up the far side, but it connects with Bob Needham and one of the Pioneers. Darren Clark tries to clear it out. Pioneers pick it up, try to center. Clark knocks it down. Pioneers have it at the point. Here's the drive. It's wide. Comes to the near side. Here's another drive by Travis Smith off the glass over the crossbar. Kerlick sends it behind the net. 1:32 to go. Scott Swanson falls down. Pioneers center broken up by Stu Bodker in the corner with 1:25 to go. 6-on-5, the Pioneers with Mullen out of the net, near corner, centering pass, shot, big save, Cugnet deflected into the protective netting. The drive was taken by Travis Smith. Well, the Pioneers are not going down without a fight here tonight. That's how big these 2 points are. They stay in a sixth place tie with Duluth. If they win, they drop to seventh if they lose. The Tigers move from third to second if they win, and they stay in third place if they lose. However, we have not heard a final on St. Cloud in Wisconsin. So if the Badgers beat St. Cloud, the Tigers could drop to fourth. And if St. Cloud wins, the Tigers would still drop to fourth because St. Cloud, it was only 1 point behind the Tigers going into this one. So the Tigers need to hang on for the last 1:17. There are no ifs, ands, or buts about it. The Tigers need these 2 points, especially trying to protect home ice. Draws won by the Pioneers. Gunther, far side. Hacker, down low, deflected. Tigers pick it up. Can they clear it out? They don't need to score. They just need to get it out. They can't. Host has it behind the net. Toby Peterson sends it up the far side, and it gets out of the zone. The Tigers have cleared it out with 1:04 to go. But it'll be an icing call. Now, I don't know how they can call that with the extra attack. Oh, of course, the delay of game comes when the team pulls its goaltender. At least the Tigers weather the storm for a moment. When you're trying to clear it out, you're not thinking about rolling it slowly so it doesn't get to the end line. You're just trying to get the pressure off. Tigers will line up with Brian Swanson, Eric Rude, Chad Hartnell, Dan Peters, Toby Peterson. Two freshmen in a very key moment of the game on the ice, Peters and Peterson. Draw comes to the point. Sent through the corner, behind the net. We're in the final minute. Tigers have 56 seconds to survive. Near side, Hartnell tries to clear. Pioneers bottle him up. Hartnell fights to keep it tied to the boards. Trying to wrestle it free is Charlie Host. Tigers killing precious time for the Pioneers here. Hartnell controlling with his skates. He's lost his stick. Now it pops free behind the net. Pioneers want to center. Rude breaks it up. Cutting it dives out to cover up to prevent a shot on net. And a wrestling match out front. Hartnell is knocked down. And again, he and I believe it's John Newman get into it. Newman's lost his helmet. The referees are trying to keep Hartnell and, no, this is Charlie Host, not Newman, apart. And George Gwozdecki sends out a fresh unit. Play stops with 35 seconds left in regulation. The Tigers with that precious one-goal lead. And Charlie Host has his helmet retrieved for him in the near corner by assistant referee Tim Swider. And we may have, no, we're not going to have any penalties. Mike Schmidt doesn't want to penalize either team here. They know, too, that the points are precious. Since the 2:03 mark, 2:03 remaining, 17:57 in, Jim Mullen has had a seat on the DU bench. And the Pioneers have kept the puck in the zone for a full minute and a half. Crowd on its feet, urging its Tigers on. Looking to win the draw is Brian Swanson. And there's encroachment by Eric Anderson. All the usual suspects are out there. Laxinen, Anderson, Gunther, Kerlick, Smith. Tigers have the puck off the faceoff. Bob Needham looks up ice, rolls it towards the net. It's intercepted at neutral ice by Petri Gunther. Sends it back in. 26 seconds left. Needham tries to clear, and he does. Gunther fields it at neutral ice. The Pioneers have to get back onside. 19 seconds left. Kerlick loses it. It goes through the near corner. Scott Swanson races after it, tries to backhand it, can't control it. 12 seconds left. Swanson backhands it near side. Bodker tries to clear. Pioneers keep it in. 8 seconds left. Tigers pick it up. Brian Swanson rolls it out of the zone. We got a whistle. We got Bodker tied up with Kerlick. Gloves are off. Bodies are flying. 6 seconds to go. And tempers have come to a rage here in the final 6 seconds of play. And let's see what happens on this penalty. The view on my end is obscured. We're getting an end zone look at it now as Needham is being held away from one of the Pioneers, and Bodker is still tied up in the corner with Kerlick. And finally they are separated. Tim Swider, almost as winded as Bodker in the wrestling match to free things up, and with 6 seconds to go, it may well be that the Pioneers, frustrated, are trying to draw the Tigers off discipline and maybe get somebody sent off for tonight that can't play tomorrow night. Bodker and Kerlick are both leaving the ice, so there will be coincidentals here. Now, just because they're being sent off the ice doesn't mean they've been disqualified, but of course the game will end shortly, conceivably, and the officials do not want these two players anywhere near each other on the ice with tempers still as high as they are. So Bodker leaves, Kerlick leaves. 19 minutes and 54 seconds into the third period. Upon the completion of this game, we will try to stay right here. We will not go to break immediately. We would like to be able to talk to Don Lucia and one of the Tiger players. Tigers have now taken their timeout, and Don Lucia is mapping strategy for clearing the zone. Tigers, we have to credit them here. While they've been skating 5-on-6, Pioneers with the extra attacker on have not, I repeat, they have not been trying to find the empty net. 5-minute majors have been assessed to Bodker and to Kerlick. Those are fighting penalties. And there'll be a face-off across the Tiger blue line at neutral ice. This takes it down to 5-on-4. So the Pioneers, being forced back to neutral ice, will have to penetrate the zone as well. The Tigers have not, as I mentioned earlier, they have not looked for the empty net. They've thought only about protecting their own. Puck is dropped. 5 seconds left. Still loose. Tigers pick it up. Backhand it to neutral ice. 1 second left. Tigers are going to win. CC defeats DU. The Tigers have won. They've won 4-3 here this evening. And they'll face the Pioneers in a rematch tomorrow night in the Mile High City. Jason Cugnet getting a justly deserved appreciation from the Tiger teammates. They are coming off the ice now, and we hope to get with head coach Don Lucia and with Toby Peterson. Those are our requests for interviews tonight. There you see the final score. The Tigers are in second place in the WCHA by virtue of their victory tonight over the Denver Pioneers and the loss of the Minnesota Gophers to Duluth, and the loss also by the North Dakota Fighting Sioux to the Northern Michigan Wildcats. And very shortly, we hope to have Toby Peterson and Don Lucia ready to talk with us here on the post-game show. Toby's getting a towel to his face, getting the headphones on, and I think we have him ready now. Well, Toby, that was a hard-fought win tonight.
Thank you. Yeah, it was. Good game.
You had not only a goal on a breakout tonight, but you were also out on the ice during that critical stretch where Denver pulled goaltender Jim Mullen. How did it feel not just to have the goal tonight, but to be involved in the critical clearing of the puck down the stretch there with the game on the line?
Yeah, it's always nice to get involved in the defensive part. I mean, that's one of the, you know, that's one of the toughest parts of the game, and you know, coach has confidence in that. You know, it's a nice feeling.
Well, let's talk about the goal and tell us how it happened, and I have a follow-up question to that on the goal that Denver scored prior to yours. How did that one come about, and how did you find yourself on the ice to make the play?
I just got out there, and the DU player made a nice play and stepped around her D in our end, and I kind of got in front of the net and blocked the shot. And then their D came pinching down, and I don't know, I kind of read him, and I didn't really know what he was doing, so I just took it and went as hard as I could, and luckily I beat him to the net and made a shot lower left.
All right, now I'm going to keep that in mind and take you back to a few moments earlier. Antti Laaksonen came out of the corner, fought through your effort to take the puck off his stick, created a rebound, and Denver scored the goal. Now, the question I'm going to ask you is, did you remember that when you tried to break up the play that gave you the breakaway goal? Did you want to get one back because you felt maybe you didn't quite do enough defensively?
I definitely did. I felt I owed it to my team to do something good for them, because I was kind of down on myself after that, after Laaksonen beat me. Took a bad angle, and he just beat me to the net, and they scored because of it. So after the goal, I just kind of felt I owed it to him.
Well, you had a significant role in tonight's game, and I'm sure you're going to sleep very well, but this is a pressure-packed game down the stretch. Do you feel now like you've got a pretty good grip on what this league is all about, and you're ready for the remaining 5 regular season games?
Yeah, this is an incredible race here for the championship. Two of the top teams, North Dakota and Minnesota, lost tonight, so it's a big win for us, again, to look around on them. And you're right, I mean, this is an incredible league with how tight it is right now.
All right, Toby, thank you very much. I'm going to have you pass the headphones on to Don Lucia. That's Toby Peterson, the freshman forward for the Colorado College Tigers, coming up with the goal that gave the Tigers a 3-2 lead after Denver had come back with 2 unanswered goals to get even at 2 apiece. The Tigers had 2 unanswered goals of their own, the one from Toby Peterson and then from Chad Hartnell, and Chad's winds up being the game winner tonight, even though Denver closed 4-3. We now have the head coach of the Tigers, Don Lucia, and I guess you wipe a little sweat off your brow and say, whew, there's 2 points we really could use.
Well, that was a big 2 points when you look around the league and see what happens, Jeff. It wasn't pretty, especially the last 5-10 minutes. We were a little anxious there and didn't do a great job, but the bottom line is we won the game. Cuggy made the save when he needed it.
And I thought he had a pretty good night on the whole tonight.
I thought he did too. He started out the game, and it was a tough game for him because he didn't see any shots that first period. I don't think he had a save until about 8 minutes to go in the period, and that's tough. You warm up, and then it's another half hour, 40 minutes before you actually feel a puck, and most goaltenders, they want to get some action that first few minutes of the game to get into it.
Well, it looked like you had the A-team most of the night tonight.
Well, I was pleased with our performance. I thought in the second period we got on our heels a little bit, but I thought that the third goal was the big one, and then we played a whole lot better the first 10 minutes of the third, and then once we got that 4-2 lead, we got in a little bit too much of a shell, but credit Denver, they came at us right to the end.
I thought your team was very patient in that real frantic stretch in the last 2.5 minutes after Jim Mullen had been pulled. It's always an easy temptation to look for that empty net and try and find one more goal, but your team looked for the avenues to not only get the puck out of the zone, but not to create a turnover.
Well, and that was the key. We didn't want to throw the puck up the middle. We told them that if you can eat along the wall, there's nothing wrong with that, and we'll take some face-offs. Brian had been good on face-offs all night, and I thought we did a good job the last minute and a half. I don't think we gave up a good scoring chance.
Well, you got some help. Northern Michigan defeats North Dakota. Duluth scores, I believe, 5 or 6 unanswered goals on Minnesota tonight to win 8-4. Your team lives another day to fight again, and also a chance to continue to move up.
Well, I think the big thing for this game, number one, we won the season series with Denver. We won the tiebreaker with Denver. And no matter what happens tomorrow, we still will come out with at least a 4-point lead after tomorrow night's game. And that's big. It's going to be, we got to figure out what we're going to do tomorrow. We lost Stewie here at the end. It's too bad with 6 seconds to go that you lose a player for the next game. But we'll have to make do without him.
But we didn't get official word, so it was a fighting disqualification. He and Kerlak will sit out tomorrow night.
I believe that was the ruling. I didn't even realize that. I thought it was a wrestling match, but I guess they did call him for throwing punches.
Well, it was a 5-minute major, and they are both banished, and I guess we'll just have to wait and see how the two teams respond tomorrow night.
Well, it'll be another great game. You can count on that.
Thanks, Don. Appreciate it very much, and congratulations.
Thanks, Jeff.
Don Lucia, the head coach of the Colorado College Tigers. We'll take a 2-minute timeout. We've got a ways to go yet on television. We'll pause for you to hear this break. We'll come back and wrap up our telecast. And then, of course, those of you listening on radio, we still have quite a ways to go. So we'll return after this 2-minute timeout. This is Tiger Hockey.
This is the city. Colorado Springs. My name is Friday. It was a cool, clear night on the city's east side. It could have been any night, except on this night, I was dispatched to investigate a domestic disturbance. I pulled up to the residence in question and witnessed two men arguing from both sides of a fence.
I put that fence there, that's mine.
Apparently, the fence was on the other's property, but both had made claim to it. I could see why. It was built by Academy Fence. Strong, durable, beautiful. I informed the two suspects that a fence has two sides, and that this fence built by Academy Fence could be shared equally. They agreed, and I returned to my beat. Case closed.
The facts speak for themselves. A fence built by Academy Fence offers both security and beauty to any property, and is available in wood, chain link, split rail, vinyl, and ornamental iron. Call Academy Fence for a free estimate, and see the difference that 25 years experience makes. 598-7650. For all your fencing needs, call Academy Fence, 598-7650.
Did you know that winter is the best time to replace your old central air conditioning system? That's right. If you call Sears now, you can take advantage of Sears' special preseason values. Call 1-800-200-1700 for a free in-home estimate on a Kenmore central air conditioning system. Call now and get 0% financing for 3 months. That's no billing, no payments, and no finance charges until May on your Sears Charge home improvement plan. You can trust Sears to get the job done right, guaranteed. So don't wait. Plan now for next summer and save. Call Sears at 1-800-200-1700 for your free in-home estimate. License numbers on request. APR 15.9%, lower in some states. Regular credit terms apply after 0% finance charge period. Not available in all areas. Some restrictions apply. Ask for details. This offer ends February 28th, so call Sears now. 1-800-200-1700. That's 1-800-200-1700.
We are back live at the Cadet Ice Arena, where the Tigers have won here by a score of 4-3. And, of course, the game-winning goal winds up going to Chad Hartnell, who scored in the third period. We're going to take a look at the two goals real quickly that were scored in the third period of play. And you're going to see the game-winner from Chad Hartnell. Made a terrific play at the blue line, broke in, and then five-holed Jim Mullen, who I thought was going to make that stop, and I'll bet he thought he had too. But the Pioneers would come back, trailing by two goals, and the wrist shot deflected in from the shot on the point. The goal wound up going to John Newman off the stick of Antti Laaksonen, and the Pioneers closed to 4-3 but did not get any closer. Jason Cugnet stopped 8 out of 9 shots in the third period and had 21 out of 24 shots stopped this evening. At the other end, Jim Mullen stopped 7 shots in the third period. He stopped 25 out of 29. Tigers will face the Pioneers again tomorrow in Denver, and that will wrap us up here on television here tonight on Cable Channel 70 from KRDO TV 13. We will see you next Friday night on TV again at 7:30 live from the Cadet Ice Arena as the Minnesota Gophers will travel to Colorado Springs. The DU Pioneers, of course, will be the opponent tomorrow on radio as well as they were tonight. And we'll be bringing you that on radio tomorrow night. We also have the highlights to go on radio, the stars of the game, Shoemaker's shot of the game. For those of you who have been watching on television, we thank you for watching us. For those of you on radio, stay with us. Again, to those watching on television, we say good night.
Public notice this Friday and Saturday only.
It's a giant statewide factory authorized new truck and car disposal sale.
But it's not at a dealership.
It's on Sinton Road next to Sinton Dairy.
Over 1,000 new trucks and cars.
Reduced to factory invoice.
Ford,
Mitsubishi,
Isuzu,
Audi,
Suzuki,
Kia,
even Nissan.
Reduced to factory invoice.
New truck and car payments as low as $99 a month. 99!
Refinancing as low as 0%.
Or up to $2,500 cash back.
Plus, if you're looking for a four-wheel drive pickup or sport utility, buy now.
Over 500 trucks and sport utilities to choose from.
All in one location.
Reduced to factory invoice.
1,000 imports and domestics.
Reduced to factory invoice.
Invoices posted on the windshields for your inspection.
Payments from $99 a month.
Check the Gazette for details.
Come early. Be prepared to buy.
During this giant $10 million new truck and car disposal.
This Friday and Saturday.
On Sinton Road next to Sinton Dairy.
Don't miss it.
Dealer installed options, if any, at retail. Limited term with approved credit. 97 Nissan pickup number 00936 month lease. 1,500 cash or trade down plus first payment acquisition fee and refundable security deposit. Excludes supercabs, turbo diesels, and expedition.
What does it mean to take care of a community? Sometimes it means helping a body find its strength again.
After my skiing accident, it seemed like my legs just kind of quit on me. But the rehab folks at Penrose stood by me, and I'm feeling stronger every day.
Sometimes it means helping a new life begin.
I'm having this baby fairly late in life, so I'm not taking any chances. What I am taking is every class they offer at the birth center at Penrose Community Hospital.
And sometimes it just means helping people make the right day-to-day choices for staying healthy.
My family has a history of heart disease. So the folks at the Penrose Heart Center are working with me to make sure my grandkids have a grandpa for a long time to come.
The fact is, you can only care for a community one person at a time, as we've been doing for over a century. We're Penrose St. Francis Health Services, Colorado Springs' traditional leader in health care, made even stronger by our statewide alliance with Centura Health. We're Penrose St. Francis, and we'll take care of everything.
Tigers win it here tonight 4-3, but it wasn't that easy, but it certainly was that close. And, of course, the key to the Tigers down the stretch is to get out of the gate quickly, and they did tonight. And up top to Bryant. Tigers balance off. Far side to Peters. Peters back to Bryant Swanson. Touch pass up top to Scott. Scott looks inside, takes the drive, deflected, and a goal! The Tigers have scored! Scott Swanson through the slot connects with Cam Kryway, and the Tigers take the first red light of the night. 1-0 over the Pioneers with 59 seconds left on the man advantage. They score on the 5-on-3 and lead 1-0 on a power play goal. First of two the Tigers would get in the first period. The second came 33 seconds later from Stu Bodker. Denver answered late in the period, 1:19 left. Travis Smith, 2-1 after one. Second period, Denver had another answer, and they evened the score at 2 apiece as Joe Murphy, assisted by Antti Laaksonen, made it a 2-2 game. But then Toby Peterson worked a miracle after he felt he had allowed Joe Murphy to score off of Antti Laaksonen's rebound. And this is our Shoemaker's shot of the game. When you want your memories to last a lifetime, trust them to Shoemaker's Camera Shops. Two locations in Colorado Springs to serve you. Toby Peterson with the Shoemaker's shot of the game. Pioneers Bouzon keeps it in. Runs it into the corner, waiting for it. Morgan, centering pass, picked up by Comrie, gets around one man, sets up, broken up by Toby Peterson. And Peterson's breaking away! He's accelerating! He's going! He's going! He's gone! Toby Peterson! Oh, what a breakaway! He created it himself, and he puts it away, and this crowd comes to life. The Tigers beat Jim Mullen for goal number 3, and with 4:10 left in the period, have the lead back at 3-2. And, of course, they didn't lose the lead. They got a an insurance goal, which turned out at the moment to be an insurance goal, but wound up being the winning goal from Chad Hartnell as he five-holed Jim Mullen, 7:28 into the third period, and that's where we finished after one more goal scored from the right circle by the Pioneers to close to 4-3. And then the furious finish for the final 2:03, where Jim Mullen was out of the nets, and the Tigers hang on to win 4-3. We'll take a timeout, come back and give you the stars of the game, set the stage for tomorrow's game, that and more after this timeout.
You finally made the decision you're going to buy it. Yet as you look, the frustration grows and grows. You visit stores that have the product you want, but there's no one to talk to. And when you finally find a clerk, it's not their department, and they haven't got a clue. When was the last time you shopped in a store that specialized in what you were looking for? Here's Alicia from Shoemakers.
Helping you is what we specialize in. For over 65 years, Shoemakers Camera Shops has been helping, yes, helping people like you make good decisions about the photographic equipment that's right for you. When you shop Shoemakers, you'll find that everyone on our staff is passionate about photography. The value of quality service is immediately apparent. We take the time to find out what your needs are, then match you with the equipment that will deliver the best pictures you've ever taken. I'd like to personally invite you to our stores to experience the true value of real customer service.
Shoemakers Camera Shops, downtown at Kiowa and Tejon, and on the west side at 19th and Uinta next to the 7-Eleven.
It's not the best rate, without the best service, come to City Line Mortgage.
This is Rob Myers of City Line Mortgage, proud sponsors of CC Tiger Hockey. If you're looking for competitive rates and the best service, give us a call at City Line Mortgage. But don't do it just yet. Stay tuned to your radio and keep supporting those Colorado College Tigers.
It's not the best rate without the best service. Come on in the City Line Mortgage.
Honey, I'm sorry.
You can fix it. Over a candlelight dinner at the Briarhurst. Entrees start at $10.50. The food's delicious. Service is great. The atmosphere is comfortable and quiet, so you can talk over a great meal. The Briarhurst, the perfect place to get away for a couple of hours of quality time. Enjoy each other's company. It's an investment in your relationship.
We are back, and the Tigers are also back. Back in second place, tied with the Minnesota Golden Gophers. They both have 34 points. They lost tonight. North Dakota lost. They have 37. The Tigers are 3 out of first. Wisconsin lost to St. Cloud tonight, 5-4. So the Badgers drop into fifth place. St. Cloud leapfrogs to fourth. The Pioneers drop to seventh as Duluth leapfrogs over them. Duluth now has 30 points. And we'll run through those top seven real quickly for you. North Dakota, 37. Minnesota and Colorado College, 34. St. Cloud, 33. Wisconsin, 32. Duluth, 30. And Denver, 28. Quickly now to our stars of the game, and we're rushing through our postgame show because we want to turn our equipment back over to television for KRDO TV 13's 10 o'clock report, the News 13 10 o'clock report, because the Tigers' Toby Peterson is going to be live on TV 13, and we want to get through this to free up our equipment for that. Our three stars of the game, Jason Cugnet is the number three star of the game, 21 stops on 24 shots, spectacular when he had to be, and of course in the pressure-packed final 2 minutes when the Pioneers had a 6-on-5 in his face, he was very, very strong. Our number two star of the game had a quiet game defensively, needed to be where he had to be, and also chipped in 2 assists on the Tigers' first 2 goals, and that's Scott Swanson, who's on a torrid scoring pace right now. Scott is our number two star of the game. And our number one star of the game for his play on special teams and the breakaway goal that ignited his team, broke out of a 2-2 tie, Toby Peterson, the number one star of the game. And that's the story here from the Cadet Ice Arena, where the Tigers win it 4-3. Want to thank Beth and Chris for steering us through. Beth here at the Air Force Academy site. Chris in our 7th Street studios. Final score once again, Colorado College 4, Denver 3. Tonight's game brought to you in part by Home Lighting, Academy Fence, Rampart Supply, The Sports Fan, Shoemakers Camera Shops, Whitney Electric, Lovett & Associates Realty, and City Line Mortgage Company. Tomorrow night we're on the air, 6:45 from Denver. We'll see you then. This is Jeff Thomas reporting live from the Cadet Ice Arena at the Air Force Academy, saying good night, everybody. Yep.
Sports Radio, AM 1240, KRDO, Colorado Springs.
Time now to return to...
One-on-one sports.
Jersey Devil Trap, huh?
It was horrible. I mean, it was the slowest game down.